Hello, everybody.
Hey.
Hi. Sorry for the delay. We have no excuse.
We've got no excuse. I'm so sorry. We're just a bit late.
I don't know. I had lots of bobby pins to put in my wig, but apart from that,
Luminara showed up.
We're just late.
Bald. So she's a long way.
So I don't. Yeah. We've got some amazing takes in the chat. We've got I am Mia saying Felix is a semi-slay, which is
semi-slay.
I agree with. I think actually.
I'd love to know the definition.
Oh, Mo is glowing today.
So shadow. Cool. That's so very sweet. I think my light's actually just a bit too bright, but like,
it's really
sweet. Not glowing.
I'll take it.
We're not glowing. Sad. Clovis, what? Yesterday got a new puppy.
So tell us cute. Everything. Forget the episodes. Puppy. Tell us everything. I need to know more.
Senti How are slay. You, queens? We're good.
Oh, well, it's like your Senti birthday slay. Tomorrow.
Happy Yay!
Happy birthday
tomorrow.
Biblically accurate season? Tiki and flag. We'll get to that.
Oh, yeah, we'll get to them. We'll get to them.
Oh, my goodness. Wow, many
hot take. This finale was worse than season 3's. Well,
oh
damn. I don't know if I agree with Malted Creams. I think that was quite a bad season finale. I quite liked this one, although there were some moments I was like,
it was a lot.
But it's
so today we have a mega stream for you. We are doing 3 hours. Rather than just our usual 2. So I'm sorry to anyone who's watching this already very late at night. We have another hour for you.
Yeah. Knuckle in. Well, no, not knuckle in.
You know, like,
buckle
you know,
down.
Get
Settle
comfortable.
In.
Get some snacks.
Yeah.
And we're going to be doing the last 3 episodes of season 5. So that will be representation and then into the 2-parter finale. And then at the end of the stream, we do have an announcement that we are going to be making. So stick around to find out what that is. And then, of course, we need to do our season 5 bingo. I forgot
the bingle.
I bingled it. I will track down the season 5 bingo in the break so that we can get excited about that, because we can finally
I'm trying to remember what we had on the bingo.
We had a lot on there, and we've gotten a lot of points actually. Our movie was totally off, but
maybe we'll actually get a bingo.
We might actually get a bingo. Our bingo kit. This is voting well.
Bingo.
National bingo.
Get some bingles in the chat, please.
Bingles in the chat.
Bingo bells.
Bingo bells. It's not that time of year. Right. So let's dive into this. Let's start with representation, which I feel so it's an immediate follow on from the previous episode, which we did quite a few weeks ago now, because obviously we had a little pause to do a movie, which was very, very fun. And this is a bit wild, this episode, and it confirms many, many things that we have been thinking about for a very long time.
Well,
it does. It does confirm them. As much as Miraculous ever confirms anything, it does confirm them, I think. Right.
It confirms them in a roundabout way.
So, to begin, we... Hang on, I have to get my notes out because all of these just roll into one. Oh my god, I want to say something something I wrote down in my notes. So this opens with a news broadcast basically saying how Kagami and Adrian, the lovers the lovers of all time, have moved to London. That's where I live. That's very cool. But they've moved to London. And that's great and awesome. But what I love is that they have the news broadcast open with them saying God save the Queen. First of all, I'm like, I've got some bad world news for you, Zach.
Yeah, it didn't.
And also, nobody says that. That's not something that happens here.
I am Mia. Just put Adrian getting down in the BBC.
Adrian on the Beeb.
The Beeb. Yeah, I nearly screenshotted that because I thought it was really funny, but I was trying to be conservative with the screenshots on account of us doing 3 episodes.
Yes, no, you're right.
I thought that was very charming. That was apparently what happens on the BBC.
Good stuff.
Tracy Beaker coming after them. Oh no, all the Brits in the chat.
Yes, yes. Drop your favorite CBBC TV program in the chat. The screenshot count is quite reasonable, actually, for a very long stream. It's less than the movie, which I think is quite impressive. And some of them are photos taken seconds before disaster. Horrid Henry B. Bigman.
People have just started posting their favourite BBC characters, which I'm really enjoying.
Horrid Henry, yes. Doctor Who doesn't count as, like, we're talking about, like, on, we're getting sidetracked so quickly already, but on there was this on BBC One at, like, after school hours, there would be, like, CBBC programs for kids. I've gone very blurry, sorry about this. And there would be, like, yeah, like, shows made for teens and stuff that you could watch.
I mean,
yeah.
there was also CBBC, which was its own channel for there was also, as long
yeah,
as I've
I
been alive.
I didn't have any other channels other than the
Oh,
the
I suppose
five.
They did used to kind of, oh dear.
Yeah,
they did used to put
that
little programming block on. Oh dear.
But yeah,
I'm a big fan of the statement that CBBC was well mad.
It was great. It was popping. The Sarah Jane Adventures was a Doctor Who spin-off, so I'll let
you
have
yes.
that.
Oh, yes. Yeah,
anyway,
that was huge.
So Adrian's moved to London, and Adrian is watching this going, I would not say this. I would not say that. They've gotten me wrong. Have they AI-generated Adrian for this?
I think they've deepfaked them, yeah. I think that's the idea.
Oh, my gosh. Oh yeah, so in London, Felix and Kagami are embarking on quite the affair. Now, what do we think about Felix and Kagami as a pairing?
So, I didn't know how to feel because I wasn't sure if it was another sort of, like, duplicitous evil scheme of his. But I think they are genuinely together because I can't think of a reason as to why he would be lying to Kagami. And I don't know, I think he deserves a little girlfriend, you know?
Yeah.
Like, this is cute and nice.
I love it. I think it's really cute.
I think it's really cute. Like, I don't know. There's just... There's something very, like... I don't know. I think maybe it's because I've been a Miraculous viewer for a long time. And whenever there's any sort of, you know, hint of something romantic, it's always supremely chaotic and insane. And I feel like these two are just, like, quietly getting on with it and enjoying each other's company. And maybe I'm just refreshed by that. But I'm
really
enjoying it.
It is quite delightful.
It's just nice to see a pair of them chill.
I think what Maple Cat says, as much as it was rushed, I think it's cute. That's pretty much my thoughts on it, too.
Yeah. I'm
definitely, it was an 11th hour moment.
I feel like it came out of nowhere, but I'm still rocking with it.
MS19 saying RascalRabbit should cosplay Argos and Luminara would be a great Kagami.
I wouldn't say no
to cosplaying Argos. I love his design. Like, I love the idea of being swept off my feet by this cool peacock guy.
Yeah, you get a little hood. Hoods in cosplay are always fun. I don't know
it's
what
nice
it is.
Hood.
It just hits.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, no, I do love a Kagami
love
moment.
To see it.
I would so rock with that.
If we move on to number four, Adrian is locked in a hotel room outside the London Eye.
We've all been there.
And actually, it's so funny to me that now there is, like, canonically, like, Ladybug in London, because that was the first video you guys ever made.
Years ago.
We've done much.
It's a full circle moment.
Ladybugging in London. So it's nice to see that represented. But I like that. So this is Adrian being like, well, I have to just continue being Cat Noir. And Plagg's like, well, how are you going to do that, mate?
He's like,
I'll still see Marinette, I'll just go and visit her tonight.
Yeah.
And Plagg's like, how are you going to explain that? And he's like, and Adrian, and
he's like, don't worry about it.
Adrian, thinking very clearly, obviously, goes, well, I'll just tell her that I'm Cat Noir so that I can explain why I'm able to get to Paris so quickly.
Yeah.
Don't worry about it.
I mean, it's easy, isn't it, really? I mean, it's not out of the question to commute from London to Paris to, like, see your girlfriend when you're that rich.
Yeah,
like, you can just get up early and get on the Eurostar and you're there in a few hours. Like, it's the same as just living apart in the same country, really. It's just there's water involved, so it just seems like a bigger deal than it is.
Right, we do have to talk about, I don't know whether actually, I don't think we have a screenshot of the of Plagg's British cheese, but I feel that they're doing the British cheese dirty. No, there's no screenshot of the British cheese.
Oh my god, I must have saved it wrong. I totally meant to because I was so taken with that. Oh,
but
that is so devastating.
I feel like it's like a pack of like sliced cheese.
Yeah.
And I'm like, now hold on.
It looks more like American cheese.
Yeah, this is the thing. No shade to the Americans in the chat, but that is what American cheese looks like. We have an okay selection of cheese here, you know?
There's no Wyke Farm, clearly. I think you would go for like a cathedral city, like cheddar, like crumbly cheddar.
And every single time the farmer's market rolls around, there is a stall and all it sells is like mature cheddar. And it very proudly boasts that it is the best cheddar in the UK, which I always like look at and I'm like, how?
I think us girlies need to go on a cheese trip. I want to investigate now.
It's like, that's so convenient that you just happen to be at the farmer's market and it's the best cheese in all of the UK.
I was like, wow.
That's so lucky.
That's really lucky that I live near the best cheese ever. But yeah, my point is we have some good cheeses here. So
yeah,
can I
ask the chat what your favourite British cheese is? Because actually,
I know what a British cheese is.
Yeah, I mean, it's all the same kind of
cheese.
Break the
news to you, but I only do this because of my interest in cheese and my relationship that Plagg has.
I do like.
I'm a big fan of a good cranberry Wensleydale.
Okay. See, I think the kind of cheese that must have been procured for Plagg is the kind of like. So I like a cathedral city cheese, but you can get those really kind of sad slices of like
regular
it's
like for making sandwiches and stuff.
Yeah, for making
you know what? I get the impression that like, you know, he couldn't explain that he needed to stop off for cheese on the way to his security detail. I figure like this was like, it was in the station.
It was in Tesco Express.
It was the
only thing really
Tesco Express
available.
Panic buy.
Duty-free
cheese. All right, we've got halloumi from Nando's.
Ooh,
yeah,
yes,
that's good.
Yes.
Yeah, mozzarella cheese, moldy cheese.
That's blue cheese, isn't it?
Yeah.
I do like the Edam.
I like a bit of mozzarella, but it's not my favourite kind of cheese. I think that's...
I have zeroed in on the fact that there is a Canadian in the chat talking about cheese curds.
Hidden Demons just put cheese, but without the E on the end, which I really enjoy.
Cheese. Jeez.
Anyway, let's move on from cheese for a moment. So if we go to number five, we cut back to Marinette, who she's been crying, and I really enjoyed this moment where she was like, oh well, I really don't feel like partying, but you know,
no one will notice me.
And the second she walks into the party, she immediately, a spotlight is on her,
everyone's
demanding she gives a speech, you know, she's the organizer of this party somehow.
That's rough, buddy.
Yeah.
That's rough.
I don't... Yeah, she organised it off screen with Zoe.
Yeah. Well, no. They actually did do quite a lot of the organising in Adoration, which unfortunately we did skip.
Oh, yes. Of course.
We didn't deem it plot relevant enough, and now that's coming back to bite us. Yeah.
Elle said, why is Marinette the only one in a dress? Which I noticed. This bothered me too.
Yeah, because Marinette.
Why is she the only one serving?
This is true. Everyone
couldn't
else
afford
everyone
to make
else...
everyone else serve.
Yeah, they could have
spent all the money on
budget
for
Marinette.
Like, they could have,
so.
They could have at least given
Plagg.
Nino like a formal baseball cap. You know what I mean?
They couldn't do that in the movie.
They did it in the movie. We'll just have to think of the movie. But yeah, so Marinette turns up, and unfortunately, she cannot just sit in her emotions. Felix and Kagami turn up. I actually can't remember why. I literally watched this episode this morning. There's so much going on in this episode.
It's because they have to be there to show her.
No,
their interpretive story.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
There,
no, but
they're like,
the reason that they're inviting Marinette to the opening night of their physical theatre performance is because. Kagami knows she's Ladybug, and apparently the reason she knows she's Ladybug is because in an I think it was in the Luca episode where they're on the boat.
She overheard Marinette
talking, and she overheard the conversation, has been keeping that to herself this entire time. But she's like, look, we need to tell Ladybug what's going on, and we need to tell her about all the Centre Monster stuff so that she can, you know, she can save us and she can save Adrian from our terrible parents who are trying to control us. So they decide to divide, like, do a bit of theatre.
I'm hearing Kagami saying all of this.
Yeah. I think my Kagami inner voice is really good.
I don't remember Kagami telling Felix this.
She does.
When does it happen on screen?
It does, yeah. I've got a note about it. It's fairly brief, but it does happen.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, because there's the bit where he's like, are you sure it's her?
Yes.
Yeah, so it does.
Yeah, and there's a little flashback. She's like, she's like, oh yeah, by the way, I know where we can find her. And then there's the flashback. The show Miraculous often does like to sort of, it takes like show not tell quite seriously, when I think actually tell is probably the better scenario. Yeah. Anyway, either way, Kagami knows. So they're trying to get to speak to Marinette. So the way that they do this is, oh no, they have a kiss first. Sorry.
I
love that Adrian and I have been trying to kiss for literal seasons. And then we have Felix and Kagami being the chads that they are.
The chads.
Snogging on top of the Eiffel Tower.
Just simply kiss. If you want to kiss.
Yeah. Do you know what? I'm so happy for Kagami, actually. And let me tell you why.
Yeah.
Because Kagami has been made to feel so inadequate by both Adrian and Marinette, both as a friend and a girlfriend. And she's probably been sat there going, I'm so rubbish at all this socializing. No one will ever go out with me. No one will ever, ever love me like I want them to, because I'm rubbish at this. And then Felix comes along and he's like, you're great. Let's hang out and kiss.
So cute.
And she finally like gets that. And it's not her. She's just been hanging out with Adrian and Marinette.
yeah, that's the real trouble, isn't it?
That's the real trouble.
Yeah.
But then they get rewarded for their behaviour, making her feel like rubbish by getting together and being happy. And now she's finally happy. And she's also bagged the man who is
the biological copy of
Adrian. So she's well happy. She's sorted.
Sorted it out. Yeah, I do know what, it doesn't really bother me that much that she dated Adrian and then is dating his twin cousin. Don't worry about it.
It's like, wouldn't you if that was your situation?
His hair's different. Oh dear.
So Elle, I'm also a little bit concerned, but you know, it is what it is, I suppose. Who knows?
Anyway, if we move on to number 8, so Felix disguises as Adrian and starts wandering around like a ghost at this party.
Yeah, it's like kind of like Alice following the white rabbit situation.
This is how I want to attend like social events. Like, I want to just sort of be mysterious and in shadow and like wander around, and people will be like, Mama, they'll follow me. Yeah.
And then you'll
I just want to haunt.
Nino's face is very good in this. He's sort of.
It's like you'll walk all the way from the Eiffel Tower to the school and then do interpretive.
I can't wait. I love it.
On the first watch,
I was like, what is going on? On the second watch, I was like, this is so funny. Anyway, so number 9. So flash over to the Agreste mansion. Natalie is on her deathbed.
Dying. Like, mum is dying.
I wrote in my notes, it's slightly ruder in my notes, but I will sanitize for the stream. Natalie is about to die, but she's using her last breath to tell Gabriel to F off.
Literally. He's like, you're unworthy of the legacy. And not because she's dying, but because he's upset with her.
Yeah. But Gabriel's gone full sicko mode. Like, I mean, we talked about this in our movie stream, but like, show Gabriel is completely irredeemable. Like, he is so awful. Whereas the movie Gabriel, like, he was very much, I think, redeemed at the end. Like, he'd been terrible, but you could totally get behind him.
He was sorry about it.
And he was sorry. He was sorry. But he's not sorry in this at all.
Nah, he's just, you know, if Natalie has to die, then, you know.
Then so be it.
GG.
GG. GG, Natalie.
Five down, more to go.
He's just racking up the numbers.
He really is.
So number 10, he acclimatizes himself into his campest form yet.
It's really something, isn't it? So this is like, this is just recolored collector, but...
It is.
It's shinier, it's sparklier, it's just got a little bit more oomph. Like,
so I like to think it's because
obsessed with this.
It's because he saw his silhouette in the collector and he thought, you know,
Barbie premiere outfit.
He's like, you know what, that silhouette really worked. I looked great in that. I'm gonna do that again.
He's found his vibe and it's working for him.
Movie Gabriel's haircuts were irredeemable. Yeah, Movie Gabriel was really giving Matt Mercer in the worst kind of way.
I preferred that though, because I feel like in the show it's just his hair.
The mohawk though, the mohawk's fun.
The mohawk's very funny, but I felt like in the movie I was like, but people do change their hair quite significantly throughout their life, so.
He's Knuff.
I don't think he is actually.
I don't think he is.
This is his Mojo Dojo Casa house.
His job, it's just moth.
It's just
his
moth.
Job is moth.
Just and
moth.
He's so good at moth.
And you're so good at moth.
Thank you.
Sublime.
Sublime!
The Barbie movie, we really loved it. We're having a
Whenever the term an acting choice is used, I will just think of Ryan Gosling saying sublime.
Yeah. There were other versions where apparently he would he went around the corner and said something different.
Like, my sweet girl!
Sweet girl! anyway, back to Miraculous. The Barbie movie's great. If you haven't seen it,
go watch the Barbie movie.
It's excellent. So Gabe's master plan, and this is part of like his big plan that he and Tsurugi-san have been planning, is that they're planning something called Mission Perfect Alliance or something. Operation Perfect Alliance. And he, part of this plan is that he needs to essentially become the evil Sandman and inflict like bad dreams on everyone in the world so that then they are forced to have to opt in to the Alliance like meditation app. So that's his plan. And this is phase one of said plan. Then we, so Captain R has made it to Paris also. He flew all the way here. Good for him. And he turns up and he sees his friends talking about how they wish that Adrian had told them what was happening, because they would have helped him, because they're his best friends. And I cried a little bit at this point.
It's really sad. Him like, maybe things would have been different if I'd have told my friends.
But he can't tell his friends. He couldn't tell his friends.
He's not real.
Because he's not real. Well, he is real. He's just, he doesn't have his own agency. It's very sad. He's not Knuff.
He's not Knuff. He's not.
Gabriel turns up at the teens party and demands to see his son.
It's just really funny. Where is my son?
Where is my son, Adrian? Which I quite enjoy because I'd like
to see the baby.
You sent your son to London, so I'm not really sure what you're expecting. Like, obviously,
13 is literally like Nino.
Dude, your son is in London. Nino wearing the like tacky New Year's glasses really adds to this.
It's like, dude, your son is in London.
I feel like Gabriel, like, there's so much to this plan that Gabriel, like, he didn't really think out this particular scene in the plan.
So he's turned up
and he's like, I'm gonna do this big thing about how I need my where is my son? But he's sort of forgotten that he sent his son away and that would have been a really big thing for his son's friends, but he didn't think that far, so he's just,
he's forgotten the law.
He
just forgot about it.
Yeah.
I just thought that was funny. Yeah. Your son's in London. Like the look is such a galactic slay. I'm so happy that part of his final evil scheme also involves a snazzy outfit.
Yeah.
So if we move on to number 14, Rose gets zapped. And actually she gets zapped because Cat Noir jumps out of the way. So she's sort of collateral in this because Gabriel's trying to inflict bad dreams upon Cat Noir. And he hits Rose. Now, so what is the dream here? Is the unicorn angry with her?
I don't know.
It looks like this definitely made more sense in the script. Yeah. But I'm sad that there's only a couple
just looks
of...
mildly disgruntled.
The king of the unicorns is disappointed in Rose.
Yeah. Oh, it does look rough. Like that disappointed, like maybe she's she's committed treason against the unicorn kingdom.
Poor Rose. If we move on to number 15, we get to see Julika's nightmare, which is that her dad's heavier. Angry at her.
This makes so much more sense. Hurts more too.
Yeah,
Rose's
nightmares are quite fascinating to me because we actually know that Rose has quite a lot of trauma going on in her life, and her biggest problem seems to be that her unicorn friends are going to be mad at her.
Yeah.
Don't worry about it.
If she no longer has her unicorns to distract her from...
Yeah.
I don't know, Jaggerstone eating her. I mean, I don't think that's...
I think he's just yelling.
I don't know about that.
Anyway, this is pretty sad.
He's so shouty.
So, yeah.
But we move on to
I do enjoy the kind of them getting zapped kind of animations. Yeah. It's really cool.
Yeah.
It's good. Move on to number 16. We've got Felix and Kagami here. I always get thrown when Felix is wearing Adrian's outfit, but he's got his hair. It's just...
It's so wrong.
But I can't really remember the context of this. What?
So this is, they're on top of the school and they managed to lure Marinette inside. And Marinette sees the picture of Kagami and Adrian inside, or maybe it's her and Adrian, I don't know. And she just starts crying. She's had enough. She's crying inside the school.
It's been a day. It's been quite.
And they're
a
all
day.
They're it's all just standing day. On there on the roof. And Ducey's like, oh, it's really sad. Look, she's crying. She's crying. You're gonna help her? And they're like, yeah, but we're hoping for a happy ending, so this will all be for a good cause. Like,
it's
part of the show. It's part of our immersive, devised physical theatre. Yeah. This is the most
crazy thing. Why didn't Felix just send Marinette an email?
Marinette sat in the audience like, this could have been an email.
I hope this finds you well. It didn't.
It didn't, thanks.
It just didn't.
I hope this theatre piece finds you well. I hope this Commedia dell'arte finds you well.
Oh my god.
Anyway, let's dig into the Commedia dell'arte. Here we go.
I also didn't get a screenshot of him Centre Monster like creating like a tripod.
Oh, that's good.
This isn't actually them? This is like a projection.
Yes. I wrote in my notes, Felix creates an epic projector remark, followed by, this is hilarious and also terrifying, thanks.
Imagine if we could do that for videos.
That'd be great.
Gabriel is pants alone.
I'm so glad that there's people in the chat who know what I'm on about.
Drop your favourite comedian de l'art persona in the chat.
Anyway, yeah, so Kagami and Felix, presumably, start to perform physical theatre devised piece. I think this is the most theatre kid thing that has happened in the entirety of Miraculous. Bursting into song is one thing, but this is like a deep cut, like we're really
so
into theatre. Bursting into song is kind of anyone can do that.
They've got props, they've got set pieces, they're playing multiple characters.
And they're standing in neutral, they're not in
Angela
character.
Webber could never.
They're not in character at the moment, so they're just neutral, you see.
They're in neutral.
I wasn't prepared for this when I first saw this. I thought it was like a cult induction.
Pop off GCSE drama. The only way this could be more theatre kid is if they were wearing like low rise black Converse.
Yeah. Low rise black Converse, like all like a black long sleeve t-shirt. classic. Yeah, it's giving GCSE drama for sure. As we move on to number... Oh, no, jump scare warning. Number 18. Oh, Gooby God.
Baby.
The babies are back. But oh, these are just props. So,
it's bad.
Actually, on a second watch, I won't leave this baby on screen for very long because it is very frightening.
Please.
But I really, really enjoy the... no, I had to get rid of the baby. I'm sorry.
Thank you.
We must remove
the baby. We have to get rid of it.
He's scary.
He's very frightening.
It's so upsetting. The eyes, man.
Yeah, the eyes are horrible. I really like this, though. Like, I kind of... I feel like... Because this is them talking about the aggressed backstory. But specifically Emily and Amelie, which I thank goodness there's some clarification on what is going on here and why Adrian and Felix are the way they are and where does the Peacock Miraculous come into it and where did Gabriel come into it? And on a second rewatch, it actually does make quite a lot of sense. Like
It actually does make sense.
It's very wacky. It makes a lot of sense.
I think
it's really good for them to
just lay it
out.
I think on the first watch, you're processing so much of what's happening that it takes a second to be like, oh, okay, this is what we're doing.
Yeah, definitely.
I just thought they were joining a cult, man.
It is a little overwhelming. But I really like that they dig into like the actual like the lore and the legend. Though I will say that it is very confusing when they start talking about like the curious princess and the somber princess, because the first time I watched it and even the second time I got them mixed up. I didn't know who they were talking about until one of them goes to Paris and I'm like, oh, that's Emily. Like I thought I didn't realize Emily was the older one. I thought Amelie was, but whatever. Maybe that's just me. And I was watching it in French, so I did not understand. We will skip over the baby, but we will quickly read. So it's all very fairy tale esque, actually. And in this fairy tale, Emily moves to Paris and meets a humble tailor, Gabriel, and who's clearly working in a chip van. Remember that? Remember the chip van?
The chip van.
And Kagami and Felix are having the best time being the theatre kids they always intended
to be. Really cool. I love the sort of like sinister mask situation.
It really does feel very like spooky, very borderline like horror film, but like it works.
Yeah, it's very like and the mask personas are really, really cool as well.
That's
and like
the
they're kind of both wearing masks of different genders, which is very cool. But like
and they swap them throughout the play. Now, one thing I do just want to talk about real quick is that all of it makes very much sense. I didn't understand the fact that Felix's father is referred to as like the warlord, like
a British warlord, depicted as wearing like weird cowboy hats.
Is his dad Boris Johnson? Like, what's going on?
I don't know who this man is.
Yeah, it doesn't matter. Like, he goes away. It's not. But I just thought it was a strong choice to decide he was a warlord.
Yeah.
So my confusion here. I think we have screenshots of this later on. Actually, so maybe we'll save it.
Yeah, we'll save it. Well, we have a quick diversion back to Cat Noir and Gabriel fighting. And we get this very angry Cat Noir here.
This fight was really, really cool. And I really love this.
Yeah.
It intercut all of the theatre stuff with...
The current state of the aggressed.
Yeah, the way that you've been wanting Cat Noir to like be slinging all these insults at his dad. It was very cool.
This was like... so palpably just like a catharsis for him. My man was just like letting it out and I was like, get him Adrian.
And this moment here was when he was gonna like fully just cataclysm him, so that's again my guess.
Yeah,
he stopped feeling bad about it. He's gonna just go for it.
I also wrote in my notes I'm just pleased to see Cat Noir fighting his own battles for once.
Sadly, this
is the last we see of him. But we move. So number 21, we're back to the theatre show now. Emily and Amelie both want a child, but neither of them can get pregnant. And then through peacock imagery and sorcery, Emily becomes pregnant.
I just thought it was very significant and cool that the peacock feather background came up.
I mean, that's obviously what that is, right? Like,
yeah,
you know,
I see what they're doing.
So they use sorcery. The warlord gets jealous, wants his own kid. And there is like a proper like, how did you do that? And Gabriel's like, sorcery. And the warlord's like, sorcery.
Not really interested, thanks. Yeah, and he's like, no,
he does it anyway. Felix is born.
And he's like, all right then.
All right then. Felix is born. But what I felt was really, really interesting with this is the, so both sisters have a child who is a, for want of a better word, a center monster. And there's like with all fairy tales, there is said that, oh, well, there's a price. There's a trade. You can't just conjure life out of nothing. Which obviously the answer there is that the peacock miraculous is broken. So Emily ends up becoming sick. And then I think Felix's dad ends up becoming sick and dies, which maybe that's a case of like, Emily was the one that wanted the child. And so she was the one that created Adrian and had to give her own life for it. And then maybe the warlord was the one that went, I want a child. I want a son. I don't care what it takes. And so maybe it was that kind of, I don't know, maybe I'm reading too deep into something that is...
Yeah, I don't... Yeah.
Either way, Felix's dad blames him for it, which obviously gives Felix a terrible complex.
Also, I'm so sorry, lads. I tried Sean, but I'm very warm.
Very warm.
So I'm going to just...
It is a bit warm. Yeah, it's starting to get a bit warm.
I'm
going to
de-jacket for a little bit. Cause,
muggy in the UK.
It's a bit muggy. Flashback to Cat Noir, he gets nightmares zapped, and of course his nightmares bring us back to Cat Blank, which...
Yeah, except it's like a slightly different kind of Cat Blank. Instead of it being like neutral world, it's like it's like a nuclear war. Sand world. Yeah, he's presumably he's anti-cat. Killed Marinette somehow, and...
Yeah,
he's cataclysm turned. He's gonna like crumble to dust, and weird purple hair situation.
I think this is really interesting because I feel like this is obviously not Cat Blank, but it has so many elements of Cat Blank that I'm like, I think that must be there in the crevices of either Plag or Adrian's brain somewhere.
It feels well because also like these are meant to be dreams, right? I know they're not technically asleep, but like it does feel very sort of like it's, you know, somewhere in his subconscious. Something's peeking through, and his brain has sort of conjured this, and it's, you know,
it's giving Pompeii.
Lily Rose, I mean, points out, do you think Felix killed his own father? I don't think he did, because I think that was the implication, is that like Felix's father assumed that Felix was draining his own life force, but I don't think that Felix ordered a hit on his own dad.
Yeah, there was that bit about how
he's got a guy. Don't worry about it.
He did it before he came to Paris. He kind of there was some kind of conflict with his dad, but I don't think it was
Oh my god, it's just.
Well, I hope not. Anyway,
I just had a realization.
You know, bothered about it.
You know that everyone's favorite scene. I'm sorry, I didn't come to your dad's funeral.
Yeah,
that's the warlord. Yeah. I'm sorry, I didn't go to the warlord's funeral.
Oh, is that true? I didn't go to the warlord's
I'm so sorry. I didn't go to the warlord's funeral.
It would have been bad for my image. Sorry.
It would have been bad for my image. Sorry.
I know a guy.
Anyway, move on to number 23. Back to the theatre show. I like that. It does become a bit convoluted. The tailor who had become a prince and all of that. But point is, Felix is created through magique.
They're both center monsters.
And Kagami is as well, but we don't really get into why or how.
Yeah, that, I guess it was no particular like reason to be like, oh, also Kagami's a center monster as well. Nothing to do with
imagine
this
if she
story,
isn't.
But...
Imagine if she isn't and Felix has completely gotten the wrong end of the stick.
Oh my god.
Oh no. She's looking like, I'm just socially awkward.
Sorry, I just don't know how to speak to people. The thing is, Felix does. This is what Felix is. He's a smart young man.
Yeah.
In a way that sadly Adrian has never been. So if we move on to 24, this is so cute because all the classmates, aka the resistance, they get quite involved in this finale.
This was so cute. I hit the rewind 10 seconds about 10 times just for Zoe with the little butterfly.
She's
like,
so
we helped.
Cute.
We got it.
Like, so Zoe. Sweet. It's
very
cute.
So they've got the Akuma.
Also, I enjoyed them just throwing random stuff up. Whatever his name is at the moment, Hawkmoth. I enjoyed them just throwing random stuff. No, it's because he's Akuma-tized,
oh,
right?
Oh, what sorry, is what you mean?
Yeah.
Oh god.
Nightmare guy.
Man, I don't know. Help us out, chat. What was he called?
Night Mentor. That was it.
Mentor. Which I quite like. It's silly, but I like it. But yeah, I like that they were just we're gonna throw random stuff at him. That'll do it.
It's cute. I like it. They're getting involved, you know? Move on to number 25. Oh, yeah, because they can't purify the Akuma because Ladybug is watching a fringe show somewhere else. Everyone is still suffering the nightmares because Ladybug hasn't been able to purify the Akuma. So everyone is still... that was it. Night Tormentor. I think I got the wrong end of the stick. I thought it was Night Mentor, as in I'm a mentor.
Yeah, he was giving a lot of mentorish advice.
Mm. Yeah, and his self Akumas are often in the persona of an angry or disappointed father. I just assumed it was a mentor
persona. This is when Adrian is I'm gonna go and tell Marinette that I'm Cat Noir, and then he goes to, but then he still has his nightmares still in effect because Miraculous Ladybug didn't happen yet. Mm-hmm. And he's I can't tell her because I'm gonna end up ruining the world. It's gonna go nuclear. It's all gonna be my fault. So he can't tell her. And then he just Astro Cats and leaves.
And then a split second later, Ladybug comes out of the out of her.
I fully thought they were gonna run into each other. Gonna have a what are you doing here?
You know how jaded I am with this show by this point. I was they're not gonna run into each other. He's on her roof and she's in there, but they're not gonna run into each other.
And lo and behold,
they didn't. Even in the season 5 finale. Yeah.
If this happened in season 1, I would have been oh, he's on the roof. He's on, they're gonna. But now I'm nah. Of course not, they won't. There's only 2 minutes after the episode. How would they do that? It's not going to happen.
Anyway.
Elle agreed.
Yeah, they were really close. But yeah, I just don't expect it anymore. But anyway. So I liked this though. So this is the end of the episode. Ladybug does manage to pop out. And she does. She de-akumatizes the butterfly. Cat Noir's left it on a rooftop for her. And they do a little over the phone pound it.
Long distance pound it.
And Beth, do you want to share with the chat what you the translation you discovered for this?
Oh god. So we were talking earlier about Bianjoui and what it kind of exactly translates to, because I thought it was kind of cute that in the obviously in the English version it means pound it is just kind of a cute fist
bump. It's what people say
thing.
When you fist bump.
Yeah, well, I've heard nobody say that, but I guess you could conceivably say that.
Supposedly.
Yeah. Pound it, you know? It's kind of cool. But whereas I was Bianjoui, I was trying to imagine translated. I was that's saying, well done, or good job. And I'm it's a little less punchy. But I put it via Google Translate, and Google Translate translated it as good game, which which is the equivalent of them fist bumping and saying GG, which is quite funny. Because that's kind of the same energy as Pounder, I think. GG.
Nice one.
And I mean they do both be gamers, so
GG.
Yeah, they are both gamers. They could say GG.
They are, I suppose.
GG fellas.
The GGs in the chat.
GG boys.
good game.
Yeah, I just really enjoyed that. I thought that was really funny. But yeah, so that's representation, and then we're into the finale, the final day, parts 1 and 2. We are going to take a little break here, but just to remind you all that this is a longer stream than usual, so we are streaming until 7 p.m. English time. So do stick with us to the very end. We have an announcement that we're making at the very end of the stream. So stick around to hear all the latest news. And obviously for our season 5 reaction for the finale.
And the bingo card,
yes. And we are going to take 2 breaks. We're going to take another break after the next episode just to rest our throats and have some water. And also, because it's very hot, get some fresh air. But we will be back in about 10 minutes. So don't go anywhere. We will be right back. Hello, everyone.
Hello.
Sorry, our break overran a little bit, but we're back now.
Sorry.
We're back. We will have tea, and we're all ready to get into the finale.
I see there's a poll in the chat, which is favorite Kwame, and Plagg is winning by a landslide, which is the correct answer.
As he
so true. Waze is struggling. Can we get some pity votes for Waze, maybe?
Nah.
No. Absolutely not. Under no circumstances. Poor Waze.
But Plagg is. Imagine being Waze. So right. Right, should we, let's dive into the finale. Let's get into
Elizabeth, that's, confirmation. That's dark.
Oh, that is dark. Well, we don't have to worry about that because, you know, well,
oh dear.
Well, yeah, don't worry about that. It's that doesn't happen.
It doesn't happen. It's fine.
That doesn't happen.
Oh, we didn't go spoiler warning. I feel like everyone's seen this by now. Like, yeah, we are very late to the party. Spoiler warning in case you've not seen the finale for whatever reason, but we're here. So let's dive into this. So confirmation is the part one of the final day. So we start with Adrian and Kagami in jail. They've been
the absolute jump scare I had opening up to this episode, because I didn't want to get spoiled. So I watched this before I watched the last episode. So I didn't have the context of
we're
going to send them away. And it just opened up to them in padded cells.
They're just in there in jail, and they get one activity each, and Kagami has a whole shelf of books, and Adrian has foosball, which I feel like is unfair.
That's really unfair.
Like, a whole bookshelf would keep me going for ages.
Yeah.
One foosball table.
Yeah. And also, like, the point of foosball is you play it with another person, right?
And there's a solo foosball as well.
I know, it's horrible, but essentially, because they've deep-faked both of their children... they now realize they're like, we don't want them running wild and saying things that aren't brand approved, so we better put them in this Roblox jail.
It's the way that Kagami throws something at the screen and is like shaking and crying, and then it pans out and and then Adrian's just on his little bed block, just curled up in the
fetal
position.
They don't even have like a little duvet or a pillow or anything.
It's a heart. It's prison.
It is rough. I think prison gives you a bit more.
It is a double
options.
Bed. So that's nice.
Well, all right. Well, you know.
Yeah, you know, for all the space he needs, for the cuddles that he's not receiving.
I do really enjoy this like purpose-built Roblox jail that they made, and they didn't just keep him in a hotel.
No, but you know where this is. You know where this is though. You know that weird place where they had the party where Felix crashed.
They've made another one.
They've made another
one.
It's that place.
Adrian got arrested.
The basement in every Sims world. Yeah, it is.
Oh yeah, so true. It really is.
Oh dear.
What in the Minecraft bed? Yeah, I've definitely had Minecraft we call them like cry holes or cry chambers. Where it's just like a hole in the wall with a bed in it so you can do your mining.
Jesus.
Dear this is the me. Vibe. Right, so this is how this episode starts, which is bodes well for Adrian fans.
Yeah, it's a good start.
Great stuff. Gabriel is back to his schemes, and he chooses that he has the power to fly.
Good choice.
Fly around the world using the portals and the mouse miraculous.
It's a flight outfit, really, isn't it? Like, that does say.
It's kind of giving... I've been playing a lot of Katamari Damacy recently, and it's giving King of the Cosmos.
It is giving Katamari Damacy.
I love that game. But yeah, so he flies around the world as the evil Sandman, which is all a bit grimmier. Here he is flying.
I just love it. Here he is flying.
Here he is flying around the world, flying the flag for you. Sandboy, Sandman, if you will.
Sandman. I love the mundanity of this, because he flies around the entire world doing this.
Yeah, but he multiplies himself, doesn't he? He uses the mouse
miraculous. True,
This is how Santa does it, guys.
Yeah.
It'd be silly if he didn't multiply himself.
Yeah. But in this montage, we had a little tease, because he goes to some rather familiar locations around the world, including Shanghai and New York, which is quite exciting. Mm-hmm. So if we move on to number 30, we cut to the beanstalk from Were Dad,
Marinette's very specific nightmare is very cool. So she's knight, but with a visor on.
Well, she's Ladybug, isn't she? But not as Ladybug.
Yeah, it's like... I just know.
I like how it's all a little bit bizarre, because dreams are always a little bit bizarre. Yeah. There's always something you wake up and you're just like, all right. So I don't know. This feels very real.
Yeah, the maybe two dots
are just insane. I don't know.
The two dots on the top of the helmet and the visor kind of look like a mouth.
They do a bit.
Here's the poll complete with 126 votes.
Flag sweep
wins by an absolute
flag sweep.
Weighs 1%.
That is
absolutely hard.
Weighs part of the 1%.
That is rough.
Devastating. So we move on to number 31. Oh yeah, so Adrian's like the damsel in distress in her dream. She I think she murders
so Gabriel is like the evil villain of the piece, and so she accident, he gets deacumatized. She's like, oh, Gabriel aggressed. She stumbles forward, accidentally dissolves him into the air, and then Adrian starts crying because she killed his dad.
Yeah,
and
foreshadowing,
really.
What did you say?
Foreshadowing,
oh, yeah.
But don't worry, it's fine. The dream is saying that it's a bad thing to kill Adrian's dad, but then, you know, when she actually is responsible for... Anyway.
We'll get into that later, won't we? Number 32, that Marinette's parents are having horrible dreams as well, in which Marinette gets trapped inside a giant brioche.
I loved that line. Marinette was trapped in a giant brioche. Also, why is... Why is Tom kind of baby girl here? Why is he like...
Stop this.
Little nail care.
I do feel like he needs to have one of those edits with the hoops and the nails on.
yeah, for sure.
I'm so sorry.
If we move on to number 33, Alia's little subplot in this is that she's absolutely terrified that because she can feel Monarch's influence, she's worried that she's going to end up blabbing and telling somebody who Ladybug is, which is funny to me because I'm like, this has always been a problem. This has been a problem for a long time now, but I suppose now it is very very relevant,
and that's her biggest fear, which I think is really sweet because she's such a good friend. She's like, she's just really scared that's gonna happen. Wow. Alia the useful.
So cut back to the Roblox jail, and Adrian, this is where Gabriel and Tsurugi-san have now deployed their antidote to their self-inflicted nightmare epidemic, where they're like, oh, well, everyone's suffering nightmares, but we are the ones that can offer a cure through the Alliance Ring. If you download our new app, Alliance Meditation, and obviously this is mega phony, because it's just a hypnotization tactic. Well, it ends up becoming also a kind of, I guess, a zombification tactic.
Yeah, they were just kind of, the evils of technology. This whole episode's very sort of Black Mirror.
It's very Black Mirror.
It is, yeah.
We've sort of forgotten how sci-fi Miraculous has become. I guess all superhero films are kind of sci-fi, but there's a line between superhero and sci-fi. Do you guys know what I mean?
No, you're right. You couldn't really imagine a medieval England superhero thing, because
so much of superheroes feel like it's sort of magic but not magic, even though obviously Miraculous is magic. What are we talking about? You guys know what I mean.
Yeah, there is a sci-fi element, because it's not always lasers and kryptonite and stuff.
I feel I'm thinking about obviously the kind of the MCU brand of superheroes, which is often very science fiction based rather than fantasy magic based, even though obviously Thor is in it. So I think superheroes is kind of in the Venn diagram between sci-fi and fantasy, right? Anyway, so this is their antidote. Adrian is presented with... Oh, no, this is him. He's trying to get out. And this is great, actually. Plag is, zipping around in front of all the CCTV because obviously he can't be seen. And my favourite bit is when Adrian's like, I can't transform into Cat Noir. There's cameras everywhere. And Plague just phases through the wall, destroys the camera, and then comes back out the wall. And he's like, no, there's no cameras.
What cameras?
What cameras, lol? It was good. But then in the end, Adrian is like, no, I really can't. You have to take the Miraculous to someone else. I can't get out of here. And he gives up and spends the rest of the season watching Adrian and Kagami ASMR on his phone.
Our hero, everybody.
Let's take a quick moment of silence.
It's not
for
like
Cat Noir bit of the Adventures of Ladybug and Cat Noir.
Yeah, it really is just the Adventures of Ladybug now. And this is part one of the finale. This is part one.
We don't hear from him again, I'm afraid.
We'll never see him again. It's great. It's just so silly to me that, like,
what compensation from Thomas Strutt for breaking Beth right now?
His plan is to use the Miraculous of the cat and the ladybug and combine them and make the wish, right? Yeah. Why doesn't Plague go to, like, Antarctica?
So he can never do this.
Very cold.
Plague's like, what's the most logical thing to do? Oh, I know. Let's just go to Paris. And not just to Paris. The specific locale where all of this is happening. I'm sure that's the safest place for this this ring with no holder.
See, you fail to take into account that Plague is probably like, that would be quite funny though.
Yeah, so true.
Plague does things because they would be funny.
it was kind of funny. But like now Adrian's dad's dead, so like
bit funny.
Top 10 pranks gone wrong.
I killed my holder's dad, not clickbait.
Am I the asshole? I took the Miraculous ring back to Paris.
When I was told not to.
And I was told not to and ended up killing my holder's dad. Ask me anything.
Ask me anything. The chat weighing in.
I hope you've all seen the episode, guys, because that's quite a big spoiler, isn't it? But, you know, maybe...
Don't worry about it.
Oh, that's so funny. Right.
Inside her.
Anyway, yeah, so R.I.P. Adrian's involvement in the plot.
RIP.
We miss you, baby girl.
And that's not all that's going to R.I.P. Moving on.
R.I.P. baby cakes. Moving on. Oh, yeah, so we flashback to Natalie, who somehow is still alive.
Natalie's still alive.
She's clinging on.
Her biggest fear realized is the wish being granted, like him making the wish.
Yeah. She's had a lot of time to think about her involvement in this, and because she's bedridden, and she's probably sat there going, "What have I done? Like, why have I helped this man? Why have I enabled this? Well, and this is what she's watching. She's watching that last message that Emily left her. Emily's being like, don't go along with this. Like, don't let Gabriel do this. He will just keep going. Like, he is compulsive like this. And Natalie finally listens to that message properly and is remorseful. And you know what? Good for her. Natalie, we do stan. We love Natalie.
We so do. Yeah. Just and, you know, the other reason, I guess, why...
Toxic this is her greatest star fear.
Toxic dark gossip star train. Oh god. If he makes the wish, then presumably Emily's back and she's, you know, she's just completely obsolete. But she's also about to die, so it's really rough for Natalie at the moment.
Natalie's got one final choice, and she's going to try and take Gabriel out along with her, which we love to see.
Good for her.
We get this great cutaway to Plague crossing the English Channel.
I love this. I love his little journey, and he's like, I should have packed a little cheese sandwich.
Plague, best character of it all.
Look at him go. This is like nobody, me playing Super Mario Sunshine as a, like a 10-year-old. I would just swim all around like using the little like power up. And I just blast around the water. That would literally be me playing the game. I wouldn't do the actual gameplay. I just think swimming in video games is fun.
Then we move on to, oh yeah, so Natalie grabs a crossbow and goes and stakes out the coffin. Now, I do have to say, back. I wish she had just taken him out here. Like, honestly, just an arrow in the shoulder would have done it. Just something to just incapacitate him. But instead, she got classic into the monologuing moment and it did not go well for her.
Yeah, it did not end well.
Now I find that there's
Gabriel standing like a Smash Bros statue here.
Something I thought was interesting about this scene is that Natalie has Gabriel at gunpoint and she's like, you can't do this because there's got to be an equal like exchange. There's someone's got to die. And Natalie's probably thinking, well, that's going to be me, isn't it? Because I'm still alive and I'm expendable. But then Gabriel turns around and he's like, no, it doesn't have to be a person. Now, obviously, we've just seen a lot of stuff about how there are people running around who are not technically people. If you like, obviously, Centibots, I do believe, are people. Like, they are clearly, they can think for themselves. But in the text,
but
they're
not
human.
In the standard. Not in what.
Well, and Gabriel barely thinks anyone is a real person, so.
That's true. Yeah.
It's you, sly dog. You caught me monologuing. the implication is that he's just gonna trade anyone for Emily. He doesn't care, which is grim and bad. So Ladybug sneaks into the Agreste mansion why was she told to go here? Did Plague tell her to go here? Who got her in there? Who gave her a press pass?
I don't remember. It's because all the people are like they've all turned against her and they're all chasing her. And so I guess she was hiding
This isn't happening yet. She's sneaking around in here. That's why I'm chat, help us out here. Help us out. Who told Ladybug to get in the house? There's too much going on.
You're right. Yeah, I don't remember.
I forgot.
Watched this yesterday.
I watched this morning and I've already forgotten. Literally, I forgot.
Why is she in the house? But yeah, this is really huge because she obviously sees this happen. She's like, and then she like gets
Felix,
her little
so Felix
Ladybug
and
phone out.
I think Felix and Kagami told her.
They got the tip off from Felix and Kagami.
Actually, this is a good point, and I think Smarty Pants brought this up in one of his videos. Is that it is kind of baffling that Marinette doesn't connect the dots that Hawk Moth is like must be like Gabriel. She's thought about it before. It's very like you know what though, I'm happy to just like gloss over that because this scene is so cool when she's hiding in the like Natalie's bedroom and she sees all the, you know, the backstory stuff.
Yeah,
she's starting to piece it all together and then Natalie, like, I can't remember what order this happens in, but Natalie tells her like, You gotta de-transform because they come for you.
It's just after this bit. It's once Gabriel leaves.
Yeah, but she sees Gabriel de-transform. She sees him as Hawk Moth, and then she sees him as Gabriel, and she knows. And what it was like, the screen cap isn't included, but one of the scariest shots in Miraculous is where Natalie, like Gabriel, like turns into Shadow Moth and he strikes Natalie down and she's like passing out and there's this horrible like blurry shot where all you can see is his like piercing blue eyes as she faints, and that was so frightening.
It's not good. I love that the first thing she does is she gets out her little bug phone and is like, Cat Noir, Gabriel's monarch.
Where
like,
you at?
It's just like
smartest thing she's done in ages. Like, no, genuinely smartest thing she's done in ages. Because, and the worst part is that I'm like, if this was a version of the show where Cat Noir was actually included in this final battle, she wouldn't have told him, would she? Like, this would have been just never had addressed. But she can send this message because Cat Noir will never receive it. Wait, hang on a minute. this is like a voicemail, right? That's gone to his cat phone.
It's like a text.
It's a text. Either way, when he next turns into Cat Noir, what happens when he opens his inbox?
Opening scene of
season six. He's like, I just need to check my messages. I'm a bit behind. I just need to catch. What is this? And then Ladybug's like, it's spam. And he's like, oh, of course.
It's spam. Yeah, but Ladybug doesn't know that Adrian is Cat Noir.
Cat Noir knows that Gabriel Agresta is his dad.
No, but she's not going to know that that's sensitive information for him.
That's true.
She's not going to care. She's going to be like, it don't matter.
Yeah, it's crazy.
That's also information that's important. She knows she has to keep it from Adrian, but she doesn't know she has to keep it from Cat Noir. So Cat Noir's going to eventually twig. If he finds out that Marinette is Ladybug, he's going to be like, right, Marinette is hiding this truth from me.
This show is too much to think about with a wig on.
But Ladybug isn't. So what's going on here?
I think MS19 has the correct answer. He will probably not receive it because the wish will have erased it. Or the creators will conveniently forget about this and it will not be addressed.
Also valid.
Just someone's going to have to just write a fanfic about it then we'll have to just go from there.
Anyway, so we move on to number 41. Oh yes, here we go. Natalie, I am beyond all medicine. And Natalie does in fact, in my opinion...
Everyone's saying that she didn't send the message.
Oh.
Well, she just typed it. Nothing.
Who knows?
I am beyond all medicine. Yeah, this is that she seconds before she dies, which is horrendous.
Yeah, it's really sad.
It's horrible. And she's like, look, you got to de-transform, then they'll stop coming after you. Stop him, etc., etc.
Yeah.
It's not good.
Stop him. And then there's this plot where the Gabriel and Tsurugi-san, they deepfake Ladybug and Cat Noir, and these pictures are so funny.
They're so funny.
These evil pictures.
Do you remember the meme format a while ago that was like evil version of this?
Yeah, evil Ladybug.
Yeah,
says,
it's in that
unlucky charm. Evil Cat Noir fixes your house.
Yeah. Evil Cat Noir is just really into DIY.
Evil Cat Noir is in the show.
Well, they'll be in the show in the next special, won't they?
Yes! We haven't spoken about this. Has anyone else... I couldn't find the trailer for it. I feel like it's a gloob leak. Anyone else see the trailer for... Was it Shady Bug and Claw Noir?
I'm obsessed with the name villain
Shady Bug and Claw Noir.
The Miraculous Ladybug is so good.
Angel of Darkness starts playing. It really is like that. It's like, I'm telling you right now, Evil Cat Noir he'll just be exactly the same, but he'll have a mullet ponytail, clipped on, and he'll have more belt buckles on his shoes. That's it.
Yeah.
That's Evil Cat Noir.
Oh dear. Yeah. Anyway, well, if there's a trailer floating around, then go watch it. But I'm Shady Bug.
I am obsessed with Shady Bug. No, it's so funny. It's so bad that it's good. I love it. I am absolutely besotted.
Well, apparently it came from TFOU, so who knows. Anyway, so what's happening now is obviously everyone's alliances are hypnotizing them into going after Ladybug and Cat Noir, and they release a quantum footprint signal for Ladybug and Cat Noir's Miraculous.
No. So I think what this is this is a bit later when Monarch is scheming about how he's going to trace them. And the injury from his arm from being cataclysmed by Cat Noir and the charm he's received from Ladybug to block the Akumas both have their quantum imprint on them. He doesn't go into detail on what a quantum imprint is. Their quantum imprint, so he's able to track them now.
Don't worry.
And you might be like, hey, Monarch, why didn't you ever
track them before?
Because you've had these things for all of season 5. But don't worry about it. He's only just figured out how to use quantum imprints. He's only just got that upgrade.
He Googled quantum imprint tutorial.
Yeah, he's like, guys, you've got to get on this quantum imprint thing. It's the next big thing.
Yeah. Yeah, he really could have just done this way earlier. Then he would have seen, like, you know, oh, the imprint's disappearing in the same place every time. That's funny. Anyway,
yeah, interesting. But interesting. Yeah, no, he's got the quantum imprint now. So
yeah, but it only works when they're transformed. Which is why Natalie was trying to tell Ladybug, de-transform, get out of here.
Right.
We cut to so Plank's trying to find a holder for the ring, and we were so close to getting Alia Cat Noir, which on the one hand, I feel like that is so wrong that Cat Noir is represented as somebody who wasn't Adrian for the final battle. However, I really would have liked.
But
to
it could
seen,
have been a serve.
It could have been a serve. I really would have liked to have seen Alia's Cat Noir. That would have been really cool.
Honestly,
yeah, like a kind of maybe like black and kind of orangey kind of color scheme.
Yeah, maybe like the cat eyes, but like with the orange. Like, you know, you get those little gray cats with the pumpkin eyes.
Yeah, and they're like pumpkin colored eyes. That's quite sweet.
Chat. What do you think Cat Noir Alia would have looked like?
Even Halloween-y, really Halloween-y.
I feel like
it'd have to be a bit of green too.
You know, Mean Girls, when Gretchen dresses up as a cat for Halloween.
Yeah,
not quite that, but like that, because just because Alia's Ladybug was very like 60s kind of like with the cute like hair.
It would
flip.
Be like 60s 60s Batgirl.
Or like a kind of like a very like cat
like
burglar kind of vibes.
Poncho situation, yeah, I really love it.
Anyway,
I just love this screenshot of it. Will be Plag alone versus the rest of the world.
Yeah, so true, Plag.
So true, bestie. Like, man's just flown across the channel, and you're really just there, like, oh, I don't know, I don't really feel like it.
I like that he didn't even ask Zoe, despite the fact that he has actually worked.
She's literally been Cat Noir before, yeah. She's literally there.
She's right there.
She's like, am I a joke to you?
Don't worry about it. Plag Pilgrim versus the world.
Then we go to
I just thought this was funny as well.
What, sorry, exactly.
A ladybug imprint has
imprint
detected
has
in your
been detected.
Home. Ladybug imprint in your house. More likely than you think.
It is more likely than you think. And then if we move on to number 45, Plag finally, like, Plag's like, I'm just going to take this to Ladybug, which again, not his smartest idea, but also it would be funny.
I'm obsessed with this image of him zooming.
Ha, smiley face says, don't Ladybug and Cat Noir have trackers for each other? Hypothetically, on Gabe's moth phone thing, wouldn't he have that way of contacting other holders? Like,
maybe if
they all kind of have
him. Maybe they deleted his number.
Maybe they blocked him.
Yeah, they took him out of the
group. They blocked
chat,
and deleted him. He doesn't have their number.
Yeah.
Yeah. Otherwise, yeah, no, you're right. I don't. Maybe Gabriel doesn't know how to use his moth phone. Maybe he's just, you know how like parents sometimes just don't quite get their head around how to use a phone.
Yeah, he pays for it every month, but he just doesn't.
He doesn't know how to use it.
Yeah, he's got it. He's got it so you can have the really big text as well.
Yeah. They blocked him.
Yeah.
Okay, Boomer. You leave that poor Boomer man alone.
He can't.
I mean, we've like never seen him use it. So true,
gloves.
Actually, because
he doesn't know how.
Because the other
Adrian, how do I open WhatsApp on my evil staff?
This is why they needed the Cat Noir and Hawk Moth reveal. They needed to know that they were.
Yeah.
I'm so sad we'll never get like a Adrian villain arc or anything. Like none of that. Like. Sorry, guys, just to go off on one.
Please, this is a safe space. Go off as much as you wish.
Narratively, and this has been existing for 5 seasons, the one of the main characters who's a superhero boy, his dad is the villain. Was it ever relevant? No, and now he's dead.
Yeah, it's...
Right, bye. Thanks for watching.
Yeah. You know what?
Put it like that.
We try and keep a brave face here at Cosplay Revolutions, but it sucks that Adrian isn't in the finale.
The real us, we are suffering.
That's venting in the vents.
We can talk about it once we get to the end. Well, let's continue.
Miraculous Fan 25 just say he has used the cane as a phone. That's so true, because like in Center Bubble and stuff, he's able to like communicate, and so he just doesn't. He just chooses not to talk to them.
He just doesn't like it.
Oh yeah, so Ladybug's being hounded by the Alliance zombies, and she remembers Natalie's advice to transform back. She goes and hides in a cupboard in the kitchen, and she's sat there and she's feeding Tiki. Well, she's not feeding Tiki, she doesn't need to anymore because they've grown up and matured. Plague comes barreling in and does something really like, I'm like, Plague, this is an L. Because he like bursts through the wall, but obviously the ring can't come with him, so he just drops the like black cat ring on the floor of the aggressed mansion, and I'm like, dude. I mean, it's fine.
Yeah, it's like,
it's a little bit of a moment. And he's like, "What are you doing here?" And Marinette's like, "This is where Hawkmoth lives. This is where Monarch lives." And Plague is the only member of the Adrian and Plague team who gets to respond to this. He didn't react.
And it's devastating. This actually made me feel so sad because he's just there like, oh my God, what do you mean? We've been like living in this house the whole time. And like, he's like guilty that he didn't know and wasn't able to protect Adrian. And
Plague's, also, Plague in his head, he's all of the the cheese comas that he's had over the past like 8-10 months or whatever along, just flashing before his eyes, and he's like, if I just looked up from my cheese for one minute.
He's realizing he's a cheeseaholic, and he's gonna
he's realized all that he's missed because of his cheese addiction.
They grow up so fast.
He was like, we were just playing foosball and there was villainy going on upstairs. I had no idea.
They were just playing foosball. How were they to know?
Plague
just like everything running through Plague's head, and he's just like, That like rave we had in the like bedroom, like that was happening in the same house. Someone got akumatized at that party.
Huh. Funny that.
And he's just like thinking about Gabriel walking upstairs and like becoming Hawkmoth.
Oh dear. Well, there you go.
Plague realizing that Nuru and Dusu lived in the same house, but they were
Sorry, I've jump scared everyone with a picture of Monarch here. But we get an actual reveal, a proper reveal in the show.
Also, I didn't take the screenshot of him just dragging Marinette out by horrible. The leg.
That was so scary.
I hated that. I
have said this before, but like every once in a while, this show, like, has a moment where it crosses over into just like feeling a bit like a horror film, and it comes out of nowhere, and it's like, okay. It was giving, suddenly the stakes feel very high.
It was giving Miranda, you'll appreciate. You know, in Jurassic Park.
Yeah, in the raptor scene.
The raptors, like, in the kitchen. Yeah. It's very that.
I wouldn't be surprised if there was some like, you know, inspiration there. It's such an iconic scene that it's difficult not to compare it.
Jurassic Park.
He realizes it. He's like, Marinette Dupin Chang, and then she's like, no, Ladybug, and then morphs she fuses the cat and the Ladybug, and becomes.
And
Bug
drops
Noir.
This absolute zinger. Yeah, Bug Noir. I don't know.
Bug
if
Noir,
I mean,
I'm not really vibing with, because
probably,
but also
not,
they
it's not
used
right.
Lady Noir. Like, they can't use that for this, which
they won't. She wasn't planning on this happening today, but no. I feel like if you know it's going to be like this could happen at some point, I would have a name ready to go, and it would.
Yeah,
be Bug
I'd
Noir.
I'd have a short list at the back of my head in case, you know.
What would you call yourself if you had, if you were like using the miraculous of the cat and the bug? What would you call yourself?
Me specifically, or the chat?
Well, I'm asking the chat, but also I want to know your answers too.
Can I think on that? Because I don't want to make the same mistake she did.
I don't think the problem is my answer would be Lady Noir, but she's already used it. No one will remember. It's fine.
Power bug. I like that.
Power bug. Okay.
Jaundice eye.
Oh dear.
Anyone else? Midnight bug, lady cat.
Lady Cat's quite good.
Lady Cat's good.
What about Clash. Kitty Bug?
That's good.
Kitty Bug's cute.
Kitty Bug.
Kitty Bug doesn't feel like it's going to hit the same when you're saying it in front of like the supervillain, though.
That's true.
I'm Kitty Bug.
Crush a bug.
That's the comedic irony, though. It's like, I'm Kitty Bug.
Night Bug. I quite like Night Bug. That's cool.
Yeah.
I don't know about crush bugging cats. Bugging
cats. That's weird. I like that.
Yeah.
I'm supposed to be a fashion designer bug. Harsh.
Beetle
Miss
Noir.
Domino, Beetle Noir. Noir Lady.
Noir Lady's quite good.
Catanelle's good. I like that.
Catanelle, that's good. I like that.
That's cute.
Very cute. Anyway, basically, she flopped a little here, but the serve, yeah, which we will see a bit more in the next episode, is a slay.
And Behave.
Now, settle down, class. Settle down. I love the eyes, actually. I know everyone's a little like the contact lens of it all, but yeah. I kind of love it. Like, I think it's pretty cool.
They're all little scary, unnerving. Yeah.
Yeah, but like, look at Monarch's eyes. He's very frightening.
Exactly.
Master Chief. No. Come on.
No, come on now.
Enough.
I can't get over Cringe Producer.
Cringe Producer is cutting.
I'm gonna emotionally recover from Cringe Producer.
They both thought they ate. She did kind of eat though. Like her, the plaid, the hair is beautiful, which we'll see.
Yeah, it is a bit slay.
It's very slay.
I like a red, yellow, and black combo.
That's the end of part one. Of the finale. So that's the little cliffhanger they end you on. Bug Noir facing off against Monarch in the aggressed kitchen of all places. Adrian nowhere to be found.
He's gone. He's gone.
Which it's really disappointing, actually. Like, I'm making a brave face, but I was actually so gutted. No, genuinely, I was so gutted. I was like, come on now. Like, this is the end of the Agreste arc. Like, spoilers, but Hawkmoth, Gabriel Agreste, dies at the end of this. He's not coming back. This is the end of this, and Adrian isn't even there. He doesn't even get to find.
Yeah.
Like, I think the only way to season six better be like, and early on too, it better be like really angsty with Adrian finding out all this stuff and that he's been lied to and that he was like barred from like being a part of this. But like, no matter how well that is done, it's not going to be as good or as satisfying because he's dead. So it doesn't, there's no way of changing anything. It's just a bit of Adrian brooding, I guess.
Yeah, it's really disappointing.
Buddy.
It's rough, buddy. It's sad. But it's okay because we had the movie, which kind of scratched this itch for us. So it's all okay.
You can sort of decide your canon.
You can decide what works for you. And we can always write fix-it-fic, so...
We can.
It's fine. Right, we're going to take another little break, and I promise it won't be quite as long as our previous one. We got a little carried away. And then when we come back, we are going to discuss Recreation, the final episode in Ladybug Season 5. And then we are going to have our announcement at the end of the stream. So stick around for the reaction of the end of Season 5. We're going to talk about like the implications and what we thought. And then we are going to have our announcement. There is a demand for Ruby in the chat. So if Ruby would like
I will see what I can do. I don't know where she is right now, but I will investigate. She was avoiding me earlier. She was sat here just like watching, but not coming close.
Oh,
but
yes, yes. I will dig out the bingo card, actually. Very, very good point.
Yes.
Fantastic. Right, we will see you all in 10 minutes. Be right back. Oh my god, we have a friend.
Hello, we have a special guest.
This is why we were a bit late, because Ruby, yeah, we were tracking Ruby down. Wrangle.
Oh, there she is. Oh, look at those distant staring eyes.
What's up
her little
there?
Head Nothing. Is just so, look at her. It's she's just, like an I owl.
I see her and I have to do this.
Yeah, oh. Yeah, no, she's so like graspable. Oh,
that's the rule.
Oh, she loves you so much. She does. Well, she tolerates you so much.
Can you get your claws out of me, please?
Ruby Doobs.
Yeah, what's, look.
What's your most like chaotic nickname for Ruby? Look at her holding you.
Porridge Head.
Porridge Head? Why?
Because so we have a little corner cupboard in the kitchen where all of her food lives, and she knows it's where her food lives. So every time she doesn't think any other people's food lives there. It's her cupboard. So she thinks. So every time like we go to that cupboard, she's like, it's for me. And she'll go and stand there and she'll be like, get the tins out. Get me the wet food. Go on. And sometimes she'll just sit there. But like other things are in that cupboard. So I went in there once to get something, and I think I dislodged the bag of oats for porridge. So she's sat there just like waiting for me to grab food. I've already done what I need to do, but I'm not gonna close the door on her head. So I'm just gonna let her, you know. But because the porridge has been dislodged, it sort of just fell on her head and made a slap.
Oh no!
Oh dear!
Ruby.
And now she's Porridge Head. And sometimes I do just call her Porridge Head. You can't go that way, there's a backdrop. Where are you trying to go? Babe!
Into the backdrop.
Babe. Oh, look at that stretched neck. So there we have the poll, the best name for Lady Noir has come in. So Bug Noir has won. Bingle Bug and Cringe Producer fell short, unfortunately. And Manon, 11%.
That's no 11% that. Too much.
That's too, slightly too much, yeah.
It's too much. Anyway, I'm gonna let her go and I'm gonna... Don't look at me that like face. That. Don't look at me. I'm just loving you.
Long suffering Ruby.
I'm gonna let her go, but she will be... I have bribed her to be here. It's okay, so she'll be around.
She's such she'll a weird looking creature. She's like,
she went,
she's so, ooh. She's so but shaped.
Yeah. Shape, bye
bye. Bye bye, Ruby. Thank you for your cameo.
Bye bye. She'll be around to answer questions.
There and she goes.
Right, let's dig back into the final episode of season 5.
Yes, the final part of the finale.
Final part from the finale, recreation. Let's go.
Part two.
Lila jump scare, sorry.
Yeah, Lila puts on a new outfit. She puts some lenses in, she puts some glasses on and a really bad wig, a bob. It's interesting.
It's just cosplaying, really,
isn't
giving,
it? It's giving Velma from Scooby-Doo.
It is. Yeah. So Lila's up to some mischief, but we'll come back to her later. Cut back to the fight in the aggressed kitchen.
Which is so cool.
Which is the best fight, I think, in years in Miraculous. Right. Such good so action. Good. And so exciting that Ladybug is able to keep using Lucky Charm, because it feels like she and Monarch are now finally like properly matched for ability. Even though he has like obviously all the Miraculouses and stuff, she's able to like hold her own in the fight, which is really cool.
I'm so sorry. I've got cat hair on my face and I can't get it off.
Oh no.
It happens.
It does happen.
The next bit I really enjoy is her lucky charming.
Piano.
An entire piano, which she then drops on his head.
Oh yeah, hang on a minute. Sorry, I've gotten these in the wrong order, but yeah, there you go.
Yeah, I messed it up a little bit. And it just absolutely decimates him on the kitchen floor.
It's proper cartoonish. It's great. You just need an anvil now to drop in his head.
There's something just like really sad about getting crushed by a piano in your own kitchen. Like there's like at that point I would quit. Like
There's something about her just manifesting random. Like I guess this is like because she has unlimited powers now. Yeah. She doesn't have like the Ladybug. Well, here's this weird wacky object that you have to like figure out a way to use it. It's just like, here's a bazooka, here's a car, here is a grand piano, have at it, you know.
Pop off Isaac Newton.
Pop off Isaac Newton's killing me.
Pop off Isaac Newton.
It is. It's probably, you know, like an Into the Spider-Verse where, or even like Spider Ham, where he can just like produce objects, or in like Who Framed Roger Rabbit, where the logic is, oh, I can use something, but only if it's funny.
Yeah. I love that.
So good. Anyway, cut to Shanghai, and we yes! see our friends from the Shanghai special, which is Faye and the prodigious. Oh, we can't do
the
this
prodigiouses.
Again. The prodigiouses.
I'm so sorry. Prodigious. Look, they're just the cutest little guys ever.
Littlest pet shops.
They really
littlest
are. So, look
shops.
At the bear. The little
so
lion.
Cute.
Like
they're just so good.
It's so sweet that like her nightmare is that she's not worthy of having them all, and they're like, of course you're worthy, of course you are. It's really sweet.
Really,
I love seeing cartoon characters being nice to each other.
Yeah, so
it's
this
good
is,
and refreshing in this show.
It is quite refreshing. And then they, oh, it's just the same. I see. It's never mind. Sorry, there's a glitch in my. So she overcomes her fears, and Faye, the character from the Shanghai special, joins the battle. She has entered the fray.
Faye joins the battle. I love her powers. I think they're so cool. It's like Ben 10, but with animals.
Yes.
It's
yeah.
Awesome.
Yeah.
It's very good. Then, meanwhile, right, something I didn't expect here
yes.
is, meanwhile, in undisclosed country, Jagged Stone, his assistant, and Luca have been training to become, like, martial arts masters
sure.
with the former like the guy who was like telling Marinette off because she was misusing the miraculous powers.
Hate that guy.
The other foo guy.
The guy from the temple. Why have they done this?
I quite like that
at one point Luca Juvica's like, Luca, how did this happen? He's like, It's a long story.
Yeah. I just don't know. I can't explain it right now because of the runtime.
I can't explain it right now. We don't have enough runtime, but
yeah, we don't have enough runtime. They're all introduced, and then the next picture is Luca coming in
Luca
with a giant flying kick. So Luca's also in on the martial art situation.
Yeah,
and then, just when you think this couldn't get any more insane,
Bunnix makes an appearance.
Bunnix is there, and they're like, "Wait, I thought you couldn't meddle in." The timeline, and she's like, yeah, anyway.
anyway, proceeds to me. No, the thing is, her answer is, oh, well, I can't, but you can. And I'm like, what? But you're.
What do you mean?
But you're bringing them. Never mind. You know what? It's fine.
He's like, literally, don't even worry about it.
Literally,
it's
not a problem. Is this younger Bunnix as well?
Yeah. I love the Bunnix outfit so much. I just
so
love that
cute.
It's like a pale blue. I just love that.
On your left. God's sake.
And then, meanwhile, in a completely different location
Hot
in New York.
Oh, it's Hot Dog Dan! It's Hot Dog Dan!
I love Hot Dog
now,
Dan.
Now, I'm going to reference Smarty Pants' videos, because I love Smarty Pants' videos. Shout out to Smarty Pants. Smarty Pants did pose the question, who asked for Hot Dog Dan? And I asked for Hot Dog Dan. I was so pleased to see the American heroes again. It was great.
I love
Doorman.
Do you think he has like vegan options and like gluten free
and
stuff?
Oh, absolutely. Everyone can enjoy hot dogs.
Because I just like, I don't think you could call yourself like a hot dog hero if you weren't like
equal opportunities hot dogs.
Restrictions.
And of course, we get to see our favorite mamas. Them. They're back.
Oh, we love them.
They are back. The superior version of Batman and Superman.
Yay,
the way Majestia is introduced literally just absolutely cleaning up these like rings. Just
honestly,
like boom.
She
honestly
she does nothing but eat. She
so true. She's everything
no
to
crumbs.
Me. No crumbs, not a single crumb.
Oh, I love it. Yeah, I am the nightmare. Very good. I am the Dark Knight. We love it. We'd love to see it. I'm just
that's
so thrilled.
Cap. I'm always angry.
I had forgotten how much I loved the New York hair. Is that because the Shanghai special didn't it didn't really hit for me in the same way that New York did. But also, New York, remember, launched in right in the middle of the pandemic, so we were
very excited, weren't we?
And here we go. We have oh my gosh, I've forgotten her name, Jess. But what was her like superhero name?
Oh gosh.
Oh, thank you, it's Carly.
Oh, thank you very much. Thank you so much, Carly.
How's
it going? It's going very well, thank you.
Was her name just Eagle?
I think it might have been just Eagle. I love her
Bobby
like
Bobby and Ken. It's just Eagle.
Just Eagle.
It's just Eagle.
I'm just Eagle.
And we get Uncanny as well, who I do love.
Uncanny.
Yeah, but she's
Uncanny,
telling us
your beloved.
She's just given us the quantum imprint exposition, which we will just skip over.
Yeah, just the quantum imprint's so funny. Oh. So the next bit I screenshotted because it just made me laugh so much. It was like Monarch goes to this entire like villain monologue, and then she's just like
reconfigure this.
Get it. She's so real for that.
That's great. It's really good.
It's just reconfigure this.
Let's see that again. Let's get that.
I just love. I just love the X this. It's just so funny.
Great. I'm so happy to see Marinette finally throw him against the wall like
honestly,
he has been doing the entire runtime of this show.
He's like pointing his feet as he flies into the wall.
And then cut back to the chaos. Just and well, I'll let this speak for itself. Alligator jump scare.
Yeah. Just as you think the resistance is surrounded by the evil putty patrollers, it's all over. Out of nowhere. It's Fang.
Yeah,
who's also learned
Kung Fu. Fang. It's Fang.
Did you think it was just a random alligator?
No, sorry, I'm laughing because it rhymes with Kang, and so
true.
We've been fanged.
Oh my god.
To explain that bit when all the Marvel, remember when like Loki was airing and then Kang the Conqueror turns up at the end, but he's not Kang the Conqueror, and everyone online was like, it's Kang, and we were all like, who is Kang? Like, who is this guy?
Kang.
And so now I refer to like anytime like a character turns up in this kind of like in a superhero movie and you're supposed to know who they are, I refer to it as getting Kanged. So we have been fanged here.
Incredible. I didn't realize that was just a you thing. I thought that was like...
No, the getting Kanged is a me thing, but the Kang thing grew out of the like hype.
We love an organically sourced meme.
It Kang.
Pop-off's diva win.
Kang is here. Not Kang, sorry. Fang. this is Julika being like, but how did you
yeah,
do this?
They have a little hug and it's really sweet. And he's like, literally, don't even worry about it, Julika.
He's like,
it's fine.
That's not for you to worry about. And that's
it's a long story that I can't get into right now because
that's
of the
not
runtime.
Information I'm,
yeah,
I'm willing
that's
to disclose
information
at this
that
time.
Has been withheld from the script.
Well, you see, it's because camera cuts.
Well, you see, yeah, meanwhile, somewhere else, somewhere that doesn't have to explain this.
Well, you see, it's because redacted.
Yes. You see, it's because loud truck passes by. See, that would have been really funny. That would have been really, really funny. Yeah.
So this is when they're talking about, again, the equal exchange thing, which I don't think has actually been addressed before.
Not really, no. Thing.
No. Because I think if I was Mark, I'd sort of have a plan ready to go in response to
this. The implication is he does have a plan, and I've always assumed...
Or, actually, I would... Sorry.
No, you carry on.
I was going to say, I would probably be like, morally, am I willing to take another life in order to resurrect my dead wife? Because that also seems another sort of layer to the harassing these two superheroes, like, morally... that's just something I would have thought about a bit personally.
Well, I think that remember he in the beginning of one of these episodes, he's like talking to Emily's coffin and he's like, I've given up everything for you, my, you know, my like my morality, my like career, my like my family life, my morality, like my health. Like he does, he specifically says my morality, so he knows that he knows he's
the baddie.
He knows he's the baddie.
But yeah, the implication here is he's gonna kill himself.
Oh
he's
yeah,
a baddie.
Oh yeah.
The implication is that he's gonna like kill Ladybug though, which is interesting.
Yeah, yeah, it's true actually. Yeah.
And then.
Lila rolls up.
Lila, if that is her real name.
I mean, maybe it's Leela.
Oh, please. I'm so validated.
I don't like the length of her fingers. There's something about them.
Oh, yeah, that's...
She's had her nails done. Yeah, so she's lurking in the wings, getting ready for the inevitable dethroning of Gabe.
Yeah, she goes in and she like sees the giant chasm in the floor and she's like, and then it cuts.
Interesting. Oh yeah, so then Ladybug knocks Gabriel's socks off.
I don't know
off.
Why that was so funny the way you did that, Beth. That's really good. Continue.
Ladybug manages to like detransform. She like kicks him so hard that his transformation drops. Oh, she kicks the butterfly Miraculous off him. That's what
yeah,
she
it was
does.
Really cool.
It was really good, and it teeters on the edge of the platform and then falls into the sludge, the green sludge below.
Never to be seen again.
Never to be seen again? Question
Lest.
Mark. Lest. And then
anyway,
and then we start getting into like. The bit that made me cry, because
yeah, the sad bit.
The sad bit.
Yeah.
And Ladybug's trying to reason with him, and actually, like, despite the fact that he's this just, you know, megalomaniac at this point, she's trying to get them, because she knows Adrian's dad. I mean,
yeah,
you know.
I realize now that I accidentally screenshotted the wrong bit of this quote. Right after this, she says, "We both want the same thing. We want Adrian to be happy." Which is what I've wanted, like, for so long, because really they have wanted the same thing all along. They just never have communicated, because if they all just sat down and had a bit of mediation from day one, it could have been like, right, look, hello, I'm Gabriel Agreste.
Would you like to form an alliance?
Would you like to form an alliance with me? I'm like, look, I just want. I've got this moth Miraculous, right? But I don't want this one. I want the ladybug and the cat one, so that I can make a wish that will bring my wife back. I'm not going to change the rest of the world. I just want my wife back. Is that all right? Like, they could probably... They didn't know how it worked, but they'd probably be like, oh, yeah, all right, that sounds sound. Like, there you go. Job done.
Job done.
Adrian has his mom back. The world's maybe a little bit, you know, a little bit skew-if. Someone probably dies because of the
now, hold on.
Change, but whatever. It's you know, it's fine. You know, I refuse to believe that like at least one person hasn't died in all five seasons of this.
Yeah. Well, Natalie has. She's just upstairs.
Well, yeah, yeah. Natalie literally is dead. So
yeah,
Natalie's dead, and you don't care. Natalie passed away. Yeah, and then Gabriel starts to open up a bit, and he's talking about. Oh, Adrian was their little miracle. Their
oh, yeah, this was not
boy.
Okay. These little drawings. I do
yeah.
Know.
I mean, also, like, feet. The style of the drawing feels, like, very, like little, like, Winnie the Pooh, like, storybooks you'd have as a kid, and it was
it's
just a bit
so,
too much, really, wasn't it?
And they're so well done. That first one actually, like, makes me feel, like, crying.
Yeah.
It's very like the sentimental credits of an anime, you know, like, the last episode.
Yeah. A lot of drawing, like, it's so hard to draw hugging in a way that like carries like the weight and like the illusion that they like the lines are people and they're holding each other and it's just there he's just bundled in her arms and he loves her and it's just like I just
so pretty, so
weeps.
Lovely
weeps and now she's dead
and then
she died.
Unfortunately, Gabriel does not, he does not give up. He snatches the Miraculouses from Marinette and he takes them and he's going to make his wish.
Really, really hate the screenshot.
Yeah. POV.
Why'd you have to do us like that?
It's like, yeah, I don't like his proper fingers. They're weird.
More
somehow.
Miraculous.
Well, he's crumbling, isn't he? Like, there's a bit where like you see part of his finger fall off because he's
crumbling.
Like, he's literally got like hours left to live.
Yeah. The earrings are kind of a slight though.
The way that he does this whole final scene looking like he's just had his ears pierced at Claire's accessories is really funny.
He must
what
be
do you think
his...
he got for his starter studs?
These.
Well, this is the thing. He must be getting his ears pierced very, very regularly because he does not wear earrings.
Or the ladybug earrings are clip-ons this whole time. Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised actually, because the amount of times they've been like snatched off people.
Like, I don't know, like he had a punk phase. It wouldn't surprise me if he just had to like re-pierce his ears.
Yeah. He doesn't care as well. Like he probably just stuck them in his ears and he's like,
look, his arm's fallen off. It's not really that big a deal.
He's not gonna feel
person,
it,
is it? Like,
no problem.
Before PE at school, they'd always tell you to take your earrings out because if they caught on something and like ripped, then they would like rip through your ear. Tiki being like, look, people are gonna try and nick your Miraculous and they're gonna do
Let's
it.
Make
just
clip-ons.
don't put the back bit on. Just leave that. It's for the best.
Don't worry about it.
It's all fine. Anyway, he asks Tiki and Plag to reveal themselves, and now we get to enjoy biblically accurate Tiki and Plag.
Yes.
So here's Plag.
At last.
Oh my god. That's our boy.
Oh,
love the fact he doesn't have any knees. That's something I didn't
what
notice
did you say?
On the first watch.
He doesn't.
But he
why
doesn't
would you
have
say
any
that?
Knees.
Why doesn't he have knees?
They took his knees.
They took his knees. Where are his knees?
He didn't need them.
Very good. Very good.
This is a biblical slay, though.
God mode slay.
Stole them.
This is huge. Like, it's. There's just so many hands, there's so many sharp edges, the like repeated bat wings.
So good.
The dinosaurs
it's
ate
just
them.
Excellent.
It's horrifying. I love it.
He destroyed
the kind of like
his own
Mephisto
knees.
Looking like
he has to have a knee replacement
thing.
For all the running away from crimes he's had to do.
It's so good the way that like these designs kind of combine lots of different kind of mythology and lots of different vibes. They really feel timeless and scary. They're like scary. I like that they're scary.
They feel like ethereal scary.
Like,
if I saw this, I would be so worried, but I wouldn't run because I'd be sort of enamored. You know what I mean?
Should we take a look at biblically accurate Tiki?
Let's go.
She's
so pretty, but also like very bug like.
Yeah.
Like, those arms.
She's very like.
I love
Yeah,
the
she
arms
has
are...
She's also kind of like.
No. No.
Hello?
No! Stop that! Finish that thought, or maybe don't.
She's
I need
an hourglass, you know?
Yeah, I know that tone
She's
of voice.
Got a
this is the this is the segment that would have been cut if we'd been doing this video wise. This is what you guys get to enjoy. So next time you ask us why don't you do videos anymore, you actually get to see way more of what we do, and this is one of those moments.
Yeah.
Yeah, don't simp for the bug god, says Roko Mustar.
I think we're too late for that.
For the bug gods,
I think we're too late for that. I think Beth's already made her choice.
I think it's
not in a simping way, just in a kind of like, you know, like just
admiring the form. Kind of,
yeah, like just admiring the form.
She got the Pixar mom build. Stop!
She's giving Pixar mom.
I mean, she's based. She's you know mother of creation and all that.
So true, mother.
She is mother.
Mother
way
she's mothering.
It's a mother.
She's Tiki is mother.
She's so mother.
Dear me, right? We have to move on from this. This
mother
is gone horribly wrong. Oh dear.
Mother is mothering.
Right, and then we get to see the final form. Now, on my rewatch, I was like, did they really call the wish-granting Kwame Gimme?
Gimme.
Gimme.
Man after midnight.
A wish after midnight.
Yeah.
Won't somebody help me bring my wife back?
I like that's the incantation you have to do.
Yeah, yeah. You have to sing I really gimme, gimme, gimme.
A yeah. wish after midnight.
I did
won't
wonder why
bring my wife back.
I did wonder why it was called gimme. And
I think that must be it. That must be
me.
It.
Gimme.
Is for
Gabriel like is for me?
Is for me.
For me.
Wow.
I really like it's kind of like they're kind of like cool and mischievous. And they're like kind of genie vibes.
It's very
like,
yeah. It's very Steven Universe.
How are you? And he's just like
it's very Steven Universe.
Very Steven
because
Universe.
Gimme yeah. seems to be their own thing, whereas yeah. it's not just Tiki and Ply like being like, oh yeah. wow, you know, we're co-piloting yeah. now. It's like no, this is just a different person.
Yeah, 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 yeah. It's very cool.
Yeah, I like that. It's also almost like it's too bright to make out. Like, I don't know. Just again, it yeah, feels very spooky.
It's too cosmic.
Yeah.
So then, cosmic.
Oh, and then yeah, Adrian, not Adrian, Gabriel, he makes his wish, but he doesn't say it. He just asks Gimme to
read my
mind, read my heart, and read my soul. So we have to assume he's, you know, wishing for this in with every fiber of his being.
But like, if that's how you make the wish, like, what if you were also just like a bit hungry and that screwed it up? Like, what if you were really, really craving something?
Well, you know what he's
and then
really,
you're like,
really craving.
Oh no, I have to get my wife back.
His
but then,
wife.
Like, yeah, also,
yeah, he's craving.
Also,
he's craving
like,
the
I
wife.
Think you want a little bit of toast too, and then all of this was nothing. Just an idea.
Just a thought.
just
yeah, I think if I was making a deal with the Kwame of reality, I'd probably be a bit more like specific. I'd probably have written it down.
Yeah, I'd have like written out a contract.
Yeah, yeah.
I'd have my lawyer there.
The chat think we're not looking. The chat, I see what you're doing. I see the growing number of Manons in the chat. I see them.
I'm ignoring the Manons. She does not deserve my time.
There you go.
Manon post.
We see. We see. Yeah, and he turns around and he asks Marinette, make sure that Adrian never knows about the villain that I was. And then I think he goes on to say, you know, just let him remember the times I was a good father.
Two
and a half minutes that I was a good dad. But this made me cry. This really genuinely did make me cry, because then Emily's like corpse like flies out of the coffin, and they are finally reunited in the way he holds her
like they're about to dance.
Don't do that.
They can dance all they want now, they're dead together.
They can dance if they want to.
They can leave their friends behind.
They can...
their friends
they
don't...
Really
and their
can.
Family
don't dance, and there are no friends of mine.
And so Gabriel, he sacrifices himself to bring Natalie back, I believe, is the implication here, because in the next scene we see Natalie as alive and well, and Gabriel is gone, and so is Emily, and his story has come to an end. And
Gabriel's dead.
Gabriel has died. Gabriel has passed away.
Can we get some R.I.P. baby cakes?
The thing is, I have other things to say about what happens post Gabriel dying, but I think this is the like, he is terrible in the show. Like, he is the worst, and he doesn't deserve a happy ending. And it's probably best that he's just like perished. But if he's gonna perish, you know what? This is as close to a happy ending as this guy's gonna get.
Yeah, at least he got what he wanted.
It is also the coward's way out, because he'll never have to face his son. He'll never have to face any consequences for anything he did.
Yeah, and also, as far as he knows, his son's not going to have to know about any of this.
Yep.
And it's not even, he wasn't even explicitly like, oh my God, I've made a terrible mistake. I am the reason Natalie's dead. This is going to save Natalie. This is a, like, I wanted to do this anyway, and it incidentally might save Natalie.
Yeah. That's the thing. I don't know that he even was like, oh yeah, also, by the way, can you bring back Natalie?
Yeah, I think Natalie was entirely forgotten about.
I think Natalie
like,
was
I don't know if she's a, you know, she's may not have been given her life back to her yet. So I think she's either just vibing dead or alive upstairs and
well,
no one
it
has
might
really
be
spared
that,
her.
It might be that Gimmy was like, right, okay, well, he wants to be with his wife and doesn't really care where. So
yeah.
I'm gonna like pick up the pieces for him a little bit here.
Yeah.
MS19 points out it took him 5 seasons, but Gabriel won. He did. He got to
good
make
for
his
him.
Wish.
This is what we always wanted for him, I guess. So you know, good for him. Pop
he totally
off.
Got away with it.
He
did.
He totally got away with it.
He get away with it.
He got away right. with it too. Yeah, we're saying that Natalie was because. Someone has to die in order for someone to be resurrected. And even though it's not quite the right way round, Gabriel is sacrificing himself. So they might, so the Gimmy might as well bring someone back, right?
Yeah. Mm.
But just, yeah, it's certainly a thing that happened in the Miraculous
it
season
is.
5 finale.
And to answer your question, Elizabeth, yes, they did establish that the universe would rewrite itself, and don't worry about it. And here's why that...
So who tells Adrian? Nobody.
No one!
And it will never be a problem.
Right, so cut to the beautiful sunny epilogue. We are in
gorgeous.
In the Agreste Mansion Garden, which is now a beautiful utopia. Where everyone is having a lovely pool party. All the gang are here.
Gorilla's out in the sun.
Even Fang is out.
Topping up his tan.
Fang is there.
Fang is also invited. Is that... Someone's playing the guitar in the corner over there. But it's somebody with, like, dark hair. So I'm... Oh, is that... No, is that... That's like Luca and Jagged Stone.
Oh, okay.
He's in the shade.
He's... But they've just been travelling the world. Oh, never mind.
Don't worry about it.
He just looks different.
But it's all over. Here's Felix and Kangami sat by the pool, have a nice little date. Very cute.
Very sweet.
And
look at them.
Oh yeah, sorry. And then also, by the way, yeah, like Miss Bustier's mayor now, and Paris is a utopia.
Yeah.
Like an environmentally friendly utopia. Which hey, listen.
Which I love the image.
Love to see it.
Yeah.
This is
all
very lovely.
There's like a blimp there, which is cool.
She's totally revolutionized the city in about a week. Now, this is what we have to unpick this. Why does Gabriel Agreste get a statue? What's the official story here? Like, what happened? Like, did he defeat Hawkmoth alongside Ladybug? And they're like, wow, what a hero.
Yeah, I feel like what Paris must have seen is like, from the ruins of the Agreste mansion, Gabriel and his wife, who everybody thought was dead slash missing for the past like what 5 years, both spiral up into the sky and just perform apotheosis together. And they're like, what?
I mean,
and I guess Ladybug kind of staggers out and is like, Hawkmoth was down here, and Gabriel kicked him in the face and he died, and then he died as well.
I have to draw attention to it. I have Mia saying that season 6 can start with Marinette, Adrian, I'm really sorry I didn't come to your dad's funeral.
Oh my god.
It was foreshadowing the whole time.
Incredible.
Oh my god.
Can we just like give Aya Mia a little shout out for like continuously being one of the funniest people in this chat?
Honestly.
Because honestly,
it's so
like,
good.
Aya Mia, you are constantly just dropping bangers.
Constant bangers.
So and there's the chat is saying, was it Emily or Amelie?
No, it's Amelie. It's Amelie. It's not Amelie.
Amelie is alive.
Amelie's
well,
alive,
Amelie's,
and also because Felix
Emily
is there,
dead.
And Amelie wears black. She does not wear, like, Emelie wears white. That's, I thought it was Emelie at first as well, but it's not. It's,
yeah.
It's
as MS19 points out, the statue is made of all the melted down Alliance
rings
as well, which is pretty cool.
Yeah.
It's pretty cool. Imagine
having to like some fashion designer died and killed a superhero supervillain, so you have to like hand in your iPhone to like get it melted down to make a statue of something.
Yeah.
To be fair, everyone's probably like, wow, that malware was pretty
malware
bad. Like, let's melt these things down. I think though that obviously the statue is probably going to be like, it needs to be there so that there can be the angst in season six. Like, yeah, there has to yeah. be some kind of thing that Adrian can go and brood and stare at.
Yeah.
Adrian goes on his like nightly visit to look at the statue, and it just kind of squints at it, and it's like, Marinette, like, this is gonna sound really bizarre, like, what if I put like a giant balaclava on the
I'm just checking a theory
statue?
I have.
I've got a game theory.
I've got a working theory. I just want to see if I'm right. I love this, the utopian school system, which is just,
yeah, it's cute.
It's really nice. I like it
I
a
like
lot.
This.
It's. Let's implement this.
Yeah, do it. It seems pretty rogue, but it's pretty cool.
And then Adrian and Ed finally have their lovely little rose garden moment. This is the official story, is that Ladybug, like, Gabriel Agreste helped me, wink, wink, wink.
I love this. I love the Ladybug just dropping down into Adrian's room and being like, hey.
Your dad's dead.
So your dad's dead. but so is Hawk Moth. So, you know, swings and roundabouts.
Swings and roundabouts, you know. Fine. He sacrificed himself in a great act of courage, and he and Hawk Moth are both dead.
Any questions?
Any questions?
Who is raising Adrian now? I guess Natalie's on.
Natalie, probably. I don't know. Yeah. It's just any questions. He's literally an any way you want to make out.
He's taken us on the chin pretty well. So I don't have enough faith in this show that this will be handled in like a satisfying and angst inducing and cool way. But this is like horrifying. Adrian is like, his dad's dead. He doesn't really understand why. He's been literally been lied to about the circumstances of his dad's death. He's been lied to about the fact that his dad was Hawk Moth.
Mm-hmm.
And like, his entire immediate circle has been briefed on the like, hey, ixnay on the Hawk Moth was your dad, and Gabriel died being sent into space with his dead wife. Don't mention that.
That's fine. Don't worry
Everyone
about it.
Cool.
It's fine though, because look. Adrianette kiss.
Oh,
yippee!
It's so
This is
beautiful.
The most beautiful screen cap.
This whole last scene is stunning.
Right?
It's really beautiful and really lovely, and it's just all them.
Miranda, I feel like you'll appreciate this. It's giving the Taylor Swift music video for Romeo and Juliet.
It is. Mm. It is. It's the love story video. Oh, it's so cute.
Love story. Yeah, lovely. Sorry. Same thing.
I know which one you mean.
You get it.
I get everything. It. I know which song you're talking about. Who do you think I am?
I got you.
Oh, I love it. I'm so glad. Like, I mean, obviously Adrian is having the not good, very bad day, but he's got his girl.
It'll be all right. It's all good. Yeah, it'll be absolutely
and also
fine.
The other thing which we didn't screen cap, but the Marinette hands Adrian over his Senti Monster ring. So he has it, and he is now in
he's
control of himself.
He's in charge!
Which I love. And he says to her,
without explaining to him that he is a Senti Monster.
Yeah, never, he doesn't need to know. He doesn't need to
know.
He's
fine. She's just like, hey,
he doesn't need to know, except for the fact that like one day he like he goes on a date with her, and he just is like incapable of doing it. He's like a sim just standing in the middle of the room, and Miranda's like, are you okay? And then she looks at his hand and she's like, you took your ring, you didn't put your ring on this morning, you have to put that on before you leave the house.
Oh my god.
Just a sim,
yeah, he just
canceled actions.
He accidentally, like, he takes his ring off to, like, wash his hands, and it goes down the plug hole, and he's just like, oh, God.
And he's just stood there, like, well.
He's just stood there, like, bashing into the wall and that.
Stop
She's just like,
it.
Hey, babes, you know what? Anytime you feel like you're incapable, or, you know, you feel a bit, you can't get anything done, you can't make any decisions, just, like, just give your ring, like, a little wiggle. You'll probably be all right.
Tell,
and he's like,
tell
oh,
yourself
really
that you can do the dishes and give your ring a little wiggle. It's a good trick. Mindfulness. Dear. Anyway, right. So then, with the part of the epilogue as well is that all the Kwamis get reinstated. They're free. Their jewelry is back. And Marinette, the blacksmith of all time, is able to remake all of the jewelry, which is lovely. And then all of the Miraculouses are redistributed amongst the classmates who had them, which is so cute. I love this. I love this screen cap of them all, like,
get their little guys
having their little guys back. It's so cute.
It's just Sass giving them a little cuddle. There's something about the Kwamis giving their owners a hug when they're, like, they're incapable of giving hugs.
They're
just kind of, like,
adorable.
Just pressing up against their face.
They're
it's really
too
sweet.
Small.
Little babies. And then look at this splash card.
He has no long arms. How will he give a hug?
The gang are all here. Look
the
at
gang
them.
Are all here. Including Argos. So he's like on their side.
He's on
now,
the he's on the team. Yeah, he's fine.
It's giving pride branding.
Catnamore hasn't checked his phone yet.
Yeah, and he never. Do you think? I know, but the thing is, we
never broke his phone.
But also, Marinette is a seasoned cell phone hacker who can get in and delete texts before they get
read. She's a seasoned gaslighter, and she's gonna have to just really pull out all the stops.
Really
next season.
Pull out all the stops.
It's true.
She's so sad.
And then we have one final post-credit scene where we cut back to Lila in the basement, but then someone appears behind her. And
yeah,
we don't see who
and
it is.
Then all the electrics go out and she gasps and
who do we think it is?
I don't know.
I have no idea.
I just could not tell
what
you.
What are the working theories, gang?
I reckon it'll be if there is a new kind of monster of the week kind of setup thing.
It's gonna be her fourth mum.
Teleports behind you, kills you instantly.
My dad.
Freddy Fazbear, stop it. Stop
it,
behave.
It's the Terminator.
Tempestuous Shadow makes a good point. We were just talking about Shadybug and Claw Noir.
Could be them.
You don't reckon it's them, do you?
With the lightning powers.
Yeah, maybe.
Yeah,
the other thing I thought, yes, Maple Cat. We're on the same page. It could be Bunnix coming through to, like, be like, oi, stop, like, older Bunnix.
Oi.
Oi, yeah, stop it.
Oi, you.
None of this.
Stop mucking about.
Stop mucking about in my timeline.
Gabriel from the dead. Ghost.
I was gonna say, like, I wouldn't be surprised if they just decided maybe we didn't want to kill him off. Ha. Huh?
Yeah.
Just bring him back. Don't worry
You've
about it.
You instill fear in me now about season 6.
They were like, we're gonna... Oh, you know who it is? It's gonna be Bunnix. And she comes back. And she resets time so that the season 5 finale didn't happen.
It's Gloob dropping episodes out.
It's Gloob!
Yeah. New villain, Gloob.
You can have season 6, but you have to watch episode 4 first.
Here's episode 20 of season 6.
Enjoy.
Oh,
yeah, that's more like, yeah.
Delicious. Here's
and there's
part
no subs.
2 of the opening. And there's no subtitles. You're welcome.
It's Syndrome from The Incredibles.
Oh dear.
Wonderful news.
Great stuff. My goodness.
I'm excited. Genuinely. What I want out of season 5 is I don't even know where I would go first, but Adrian needs to find out that he's a centre monster, that his dad was Hawk Moth, and that not that Ladybug killed his dad, it just didn't really happen. But...
The worst part is that I'm like, if I was Marinette, I also would be like, what are you going to do? Just be like, oh yeah, by the way, your dad was Hawk Moth. Just FYI.
Yeah, that's
like,
true. It's, yeah. Like,
it's not an easy thing to say. Like, already she had to tell him he's dead. And then Gabriel's literally, his last words were like, don't tell Adrian, by the way.
Oh, that's true. Yeah. So she's like, she has that kind of, oh, I have to keep up this lie because my honor. And
so
it's
interesting. It's really, really interesting.
I forgot that she made that promise. So that's kind of, she's like, I've got a moral code now, I've decided, so I can't.
It's Deku from Miraculous Zoom. Coming through the portal.
I really like it's Ruby because just based on the POV of this image, it implies that Ruby is a giant cat.
Yeah.
It's a Clifford the Big Red Dog situation.
Yeah, well, you never know.
I really enjoy it. That's how I feel when I wake up and she's standing over me. Like,
maybe it's Chloe.
Oh, Crystal, that's a really good theory. So I don't know if it's Time Tagger, but I think, future Hawk Moth, if she ends, like Lila, if she ends up getting all the Miraculouses, she could send someone back in time, or herself, she could go back in time and be like, hey, this is how you become me.
Yeah. Interesting. Either way, many, many questions. Should we have a look at our bingo sheet, our bingle sheet, yeah, and see how we're doing?
Bingo time!
Here we go. Look, I did have it loaded up and ready to go. I'm a genius.
I'm so impressed.
I know.
I'm so impressed.
So, final scorings are Felix Peacock outfit.
Would you like me to
please tick these off as we go?
Yes, give me just brilliant. A second. Let me just get my little diary going. Hang on. Let me find a page.
Oh my god, do you know what? I think we've got a bingo immediately on this top row.
Oh,
yeah, I also think we have I think we have another bingo actually.
Slow down, I'm trying to find an empty page.
Oh my gosh. I wish I could do this live, but I'm
we have a bingle.
No, it's alright. It's alright. It makes me feel like I have purpose.
All right. Felix, we
have 4x4. Give me a second.
You keep speaking. We keep speaking like you're ready and then you're not. We'll just wait.
We'll talk
between ourselves.
Talk between ourselves.
Okay, I'm ready.
Right.
Felix Peacock outfit.
Ding, ding,
yeah.
Ding.
Hell yeah.
Lila villain moment. Check.
Hell yeah.
Natalie double agent.
Not until the very last episode, check. But yeah, check. Still counts.
Center monster theory resolution. Check.
Big check.
Ding, ding, ding.
Ding, ding, ding. That first row.
Second row. Ladrian got no Ladrian. We're still starving.
No
Ladrian.
Ladrian will never happen ever again now.
It's so sad.
So
yeah.
Sad. But... Adrian discovers Gabriel's secret. Sadly, not. That would have been good, wouldn't it? But never mind. Hawkmoth discovers Cat Noir's identity. Nope. Did not happen.
Nope.
Bunnix. Ding, ding, ding.
Yes.
New Gabriel villain outfit. Ding, ding, ding.
Yes.
We actually got two of those because we got Monarch and
sparkly
blingy.
Kwame Lore episode. We didn't get a Lore episode. We did get more Kwame Lore.
The thing
but not
is,
a whole
I remember.
I don't know. I was gonna say like, does biblically accurate count?
Not quite, because I remember our thinking behind this was that you know how you remember the episode Feast where Master Fu had, there was like a whole episode about the temple. That was, I think, what we put this on here because we were like, there's going to be an episode set, like, in the Kwame. Like, so I just don't know that we can say, like, if it had just been Kwame lore, fine. But it wasn't a Kwame lore episode.
Mm-hmm.
So, no. Ladybug gets shoes. No. But what I will say, it looks like Shadybug has shoes, so...
Shadybug has shoes, that's her villain arc, and she just immediately
Luminara is so devastated
she
about this. Five seasons and a movie and no shoes.
When your bingo card would make a better season than the actual season. Well, not good. No,
historical figure is a miraculous holder. Ding, ding, ding. That fourth column is looking good. New art style montage. There were quite a few of these.
Yes.
I think so, yeah.
Yeah, ding, ding, ding.
Cat Noir power upgrade.
Yes.
Because he can now do cataclysm multiple
times. They don't have to worry about de-transforming now.
They gave him a power upgrade and then immediately nerfed him, but they did give him a power upgrade.
Yeah. Fake reveal. I can't even remember what episode, but almost for certain.
No, because when we put fake reveal here, we mean like, you know, like an Oblivio reveal where it gets actually reversed, where or like all that nonsense with the Snake Miraculous in season 4, you know, where they keep rolling it back. So I don't think there's a fake reveal here.
Ooh, okay.
Actual reveal. We never I know that we meant this to be the love square, but we never wrote that it had to be the love square.
I think if we're talking technically and legally, we can get away with this one.
Technically and legally. That means we get another bingle.
Legally.
Two bingles.
We got two whole bingles. That's incredible.
Two whole bingles.
Well done us.
I am so proud of us, guys.
We never get this.
We never get a win.
Two bingles.
That's like... We got over 50% of that correct. So pretty
well
good
done.
Season.
Yeah.
Well done, everyone.
Yeah.
Sorry, I just had to write two bingles because the joy it's giving me.
Two bingles.
Two whole bingles. Guys, I'm so proud of us.
Yeah.
Well done, everyone. Well done to all
so
involved.
That was season 5. But it was over in the blink of an eye because it all just came out so
quickly
towards the end.
I know.
Honestly.
Well,
like
thanks for joining us for the chaos that we have.
The final bingle.
The final bingle.
The final bingle.
The final bingle. Well, we have reached the end of our mega stream, and we've reached the end of season 5. And so it's probably time for our announcement, which we are going to share with you now. Guys, we got our... This all sounds very
Yeah,
cool,
yeah, but... yeah. We have notes on like
we have yes. notes. So let me just
It's kind of big news.
It's big news. So settle in.
Big bingle news.
It's big bingle news. Well, it's not bingle news.
Big bingle news.
It's not bingle
news. It's nothing to do with bingles.
Yeah, we have some news to share with you all.
Oh, but first, Tina Michelle, thank you so much.
Oh, we have a super chat.
Thank you for the super chat.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Those of you who've been with us a long time, like, we've been making Ladybug content for the past seven years.
Shocking.
Which genuinely did that wrong, 7 years, which is nearly as long as the show has been airing.
Don't worry. So yeah, we've had, dare I say, we've had a miraculous time creating videos and creating reactions with all of you lovely people.
But with the movie coming out and season 5 coming to a close, we have come to a decision.
So this is just really, this isn't fun news, I'm sorry, but with a heavy heart, we've decided it's time to close this chapter, and our last miraculous stream will be on Tuesday the 29th of August.
That's in 2 weeks, so please
note it down.
Oh my god, we wrote this up and now I'm like, we're having to say it, and this is,
I know.
Anyway.
No, it's real. But yeah, note it down. And thank you so much for coming along on the ride with us. We've done our absolute best to read every single comment and message that you sent us, and some of them have just been the loveliest ever. We're very, very grateful for you guys.
Yeah, we're really gonna miss the chat. I'm so sorry.
Stop it!
We're gonna miss screaming about all the latest episodes.
Anyway. Stop it! You gotta stop it.
Oh no, we're really sad as well. It's we're gonna miss all the theories and all the chatting.
Sorry. But we will still be here in spirit, because our video catalog will still remain. You can still watch all of the recordings of streams. You can watch reacts. You can watch our designated CMBs. We're still sort of here, and you can come back and visit the old stuff anytime.
Get
akumatized.
Please, nobody get akumatized. I'm gonna go slightly off script here, and look, we love you guys so much. And we are gutted that we've gotta wind this down. It's been a really long time that we've been doing this stuff.
Unfortunately, there are outside factors to consider and whatnot. But
everything's
calling Hawk Moth right now. Stop it! Put the phone down.
Stop! No. Stop! You're making us laugh. Cut the camera.
I'm gonna go emo now. I'm gonna become the new Hawk Moth.
Thank you so much, Louise.
Ethan Reynolds just put in the chat, does this mean we're taking a break or something? Just to be completely transparent, it means we are ending our miraculous content.
Yeah,
we will not be making any new stuff even when season 6 does come out. Thank you so much, Elizabeth. Thank you, that's so kind. Oh my god, congratulations on your wedding!
Congratulations on the happy couple!
So it's just, we've been doing this for it's coming up to 8 years now. It's been like a long, long time.
Which is
terrifying. We're all in very different stages of our lives than where we were 7 to 8 years ago. And we're just unable to continue doing
there are outside factors that aren't really, we can't logically keep things going.
Us three are all still really, really good friends and everything. It's nothing like that.
There's no drama.
To clarify, there's absolutely no drama.
A couple breakup. No. You know?
No, There will be no discourse. We are still the best of friends.
We're fine.
So
we're fine. We are actually hoping that this enables us to see each other more.
We will be having a stream in 2 weeks' time. I think we already said the 29th of August. Please come and join us. We're gonna have a lot of fun. We're gonna maybe the Bling Warehouse will make an appearance. Oh, thank you, Maple Cat.
Thank you, Maple Cat. We'll miss you too.
Guys,
I'm sorry, we have to call it off. They're sending Manon to me for this. Oh, I can't.
No. Not Mr. Banana.
Mr. Banana saying that this was not peachy. It really, really tickled me.
We will still be watching the show and stuff, but obviously just won't be making the videos.
So next stream we will send us suggestions for things you want to see. We're going to do maybe some fun moments, look back at some of the funny things we've had over the years, the memories we've had with you guys, things like the tiki pot will be there. All of my little pals will be there. And we'll maybe play some Bling Warehouse, maybe some Roblox, but let us know, send us some messages if you forgot.
Yeah.
Maybe we'll try and make a community post about the last stream, and then you can make some suggestions. We are trying to get that reaction unblocked, but copyright is bottom text.
Yellow Umbrella, we'll make a community post on YouTube, or you can send stuff to our Instagram. And it's Explore, so Cosplay Revolutions and our main channel will still be making cosplay content. We have a new My Hero Academia project coming out very, very soon. There's a vlog coming out on this channel soon. So there's still going to be stuff, but it just won't be the Miraculous stuff with the three of us anymore.
But thank you all for joining us. I can now finish my last bit of the statement, but as they say in Paris, au revoir. Which means goodbye until we meet again. So we will still, and you follow us on social media, and all of a tear is falling out of my banana costume.
Oh no!
We love you guys, and you call us queens, but you guys are all queens and kings and royalty
and monarchy. You're on right.
Well, I don't know that monarchy is what we can
that,
say.
That was
monarchy.
Yeah, that was
if you were an aristocracy.
Listen. If you want to be an evil supervillain in a purple jacket, I feel like passing words should be that you can.
Of course, yeah,
I believe
you
in
can
you.
Do that if you want. But yeah, so please come join us. Come join us in 2 weeks' time. We will let you know when the timings will be. Come make some suggestions. We will have a party, and it's going to be a lot of fun.
It's going to be great.
Put it on your calendars, guys.
Yeah,
and maybe we can
imagine it's going to be a little bit rogue.
It's
going to
be a little
silly. So
and maybe we can make a season 6 bingle sheet, even if we're not going to be here to stream it.
We could we can pass on the bingle to you.
Yeah.
Oh, Elizabeth.
I'm going to get akumatized.
I'm gonna get akumatized now.
Yeah. It's really sad. It's the end of an era. But
it is.
We haven't, obviously. We haven't been able to do any of the stuff without you guys, and it's
grateful.
So fun doing these streams, and it's
really
sad news, but I hope you guys understand that
Lady Noir Queen, sorry I didn't come to your funeral. If you miss the stream in 2 weeks, please go and comment anything you want. That's so funny.
Oh my god,
I'm sorry I didn't come to your funeral.
Sorry I didn't come to your funeral. Oh my gosh. You guys are so funny. I will miss this so much.
So funny.
Oh my goodness.
Oh my god, name the stream the final day. Let's see them five
final,
finale.
Yeah. Oh my god.
Can we the pretend the airplanes are the night sky?
Oh,
I came to your funeral.
You can come to our funeral.
We'll
in 2 weeks. Sorry, I may not be at your funeral.
Oh, God. But like we said, you can watch all the streams on the channel, and having gone through them to like make a little recap thing for the next stream,
they are so,
so
good.
Much of it. Yeah. Like there's hours of stuff to watch, and I know it's not the same as there being fresh episode reactions.
Yeah, but
definitely, if you are feeling like there is a little miraculous trio shaped hole in your life, you should definitely go and rewatch them because there's so much, and they are
so
silly.
I've rewatched a bunch of them. They are fun. Anyway,
we love you guys. We love the show, and we don't want to just drop it on you next time.
Bye. We wanted to give you warning. We wanted to invite you to the funeral.
Consider this your funeral invite.
This is the funeral invite.
Please RSVP.
I came to your funeral.
I will be at your funeral.
On a actual serious note, I don't think we ever thought that we would have like a community that would like come back for us, and that's really sweet, and like we really love you guys, and you do make the streams, and
you really do. Just to echo what Luminara said, you know, when we started making, we started making cosplay videos, and then we started talking and making reactions.
And then people liked our opinions, which was really nice.
We've just, it's been such an amazing ride, and let's have a party or a funeral in 2 weeks' time.
And also, I do owe this show a lot because... And I'm in the Zoom window, so I don't know if I'll be pointing in the right place.
You're in the bottom Zoom window.
Okay.
There you go.
Alright, if I hadn't have watched this little bug and cat show, I wouldn't have these guys, who are deeply important to me. So, that's very, very special to me.
We wouldn't have you either. We all kind of met because of this show. We all met together.
It's
but we're still gonna be friends afterwards. That's the thing.
We're fine now. Like
we're good.
We're all good. But yeah, you know, like we said, outside things, and life happens. So you know, we are much older than we were when we started this.
Rebecca Stewart, you will definitely there's some more content coming out on the 864 channel that will have me and Miranda will be in various capacities in it. And you know, I might still be kicking around on this channel as well in other projects. But it won't be quite the same, but you know,
we're not dipping entirely, we'll still be around, like,
well no, as in like we are stopping the miraculous stuff entirely, but it's in other content on the channel.
But who knows, never say never. But we'll
I still think we should do some hangout where we can cosplay silly versions of villains, so I'm still holding out hope. I just want to be Party Crasher.
We can crash that party. Maybe I'll get a disco ball for the stream.
Actually,
I have a disco ball. I have a little disco ball. It's a Christmas decoration. I will make sure I bring that and I will decorate. Thank you all so much. And sorry to end
Jeremy West, it's not because we got tired of Miraculous.
No, we still love Miraculous.
We still love Miraculous, and we'll still be watching
watching my life.
We're in two.
I'm in it now.
I didn't want anyone to think that it's because we've like lost our love for the show. We've been watching the show.
I will be watching the special.
I'm very excited for the special. It's just the actual putting together the show that we do and the content and stuff. We're just not able to do it anymore. But it's not because we don't love Miraculous anymore.
I will love Miraculous.
And I will
always... For reasons I expressed earlier, like, I owe it a lot. I have very close friends because of it. And so I will never be able to cut myself off completely from Miraculous.
Not at all.
No matter how silly it gets.
Exactly. Right, we're going to leave it there. Sorry that we've had to end that on such a sad
bombshell.
But we're going to see you in
2 weeks.
Yeah.
So yeah, please do join us for the party of the century. and bring your favorite moments. Bring your
venue, Bling Warehouse.
Bling Warehouse, bring your best bling, and we will have a fabulous time. Thank you all so much. And we'll see you next time. Bye-bye.
Yeah, let us know what you want to see.
Au revoir. Bye.